Maybe you're somebody, or you ain't nobody.
Somehow they hate her. Ow. Her two kids that she kept because she thought them dudes was going to give a fuck. But then they ducked out on her ass. Fuck that silly slut. Even though that bitch do got a big ass butt. But I won't fuck her though. Because it's your daughter. But get the daughter out of my face before the slaughter. I don't like your daughter, bitch.
I told you he answered shit. Silence is golden. They say no sound.
Silence is golden? Yeah.
Back up.
Are we back up? Okay, well, listen. I just want to say this. Today I saw my elderly man with a 30-year-old body go out there and give my man Zoe all he could handle.
All I could handle.
I want to say this. Zoe wasn't the game.
Boom, but there it is.
We're going to play the game.
Why you tell who won the game?
They ain't going to win. Come on,
look,
man.
Look, man, Zoe won the game, but we're going to play the game in its entirety at the end of the show. I hope you can stomach it. The game probably lasted, what, about 10, 15 minutes?
It was longer than that.
Bobby dunked on Zoe.
About 15, 20.
Let me tell you something. Bobby put on that tank top. And it was
on. Got like some superpowers. That tank top was reeking of brute. And that motherfucker came out with civil rights strength.
It was a musty bitch.
Pushed me around.
Right. It was a musty bitch at the playground rooting on Bobby. And that man got in a fight because she was like, kick his ass, Bobby.
I tried.
I'm telling y'all, don't sleep on Bobby, man. Bobby got energy. Energy.
Oh, I wasn't going to let Bobby beat me.
Love it.
Yeah, he right about that. He had to bring his A game.
And it wasn't my A game. It was more like my A game.
Here we go. Here goes game number two.
Your A game.
No, it was my A game. I ain't played in 6 months, but I still whooped your ass.
I ain't played five years.
On your bike.
Don't make us have to repeat this shit.
But look,
your ass whooping.
I'm going to put y'all up on something, man. I know Bobby. Bobby smokes squares. So for Bobby to have that much energy.
Oh, it's kind of.
No, it was awesome, man.
And took his field.
I am underestimating Bobby.
Oh, yeah.
Bobby shoot the first shot.
Are you all right, though? We need to, because that's.
I get the ball comes off. Bobby slips and falls.
Oh, my God. That scared me.
I get the rebound. I'm getting ready to go up. This motherfucker right there. I said, God,
he got up.
I can't walk to the hoop.
No.
But that boy's energy is
off the
chart.
I don't think y'all understand, man. I'm from a generation where we spell it P-R-I-D-E. I'm not going to just let you do me like that.
Oh, well, yeah. Okay. That's true.
That's not
it's
happening.
It's called slave basketball. If you lost, you died. You'd have got lynched later on that night.
It was, in my opinion, a very West Coast game.
West Coast?
A lot of jump shots.
Oh. Yeah, it was a West Coast game because if this was Chicago, we probably wouldn't have been able to do the show. They'd be doing the show like this. Yeah, well, we played a game. And, you know, he won, but I'm just saying, he had to bolt me in my eye like that. Ain't nobody about to win and be able to do a show where I'm from.
Oh, my God.
This is the 5150 show, and you know what we do in the beginning of the show? We had a homegirl, Darlene, go in with her loose talk about bullshit.
Yeah. Yes, that is it. That is exactly what it is. It's a little day of mourning today.
Day of mourning?
Not, well, it's Veterans Day, of course. You know, we're remembering all the veterans that served.
What anybody, did they do?
Anybody?
Oh, no? Yeah, I'm a veteran.
You're a veteran?
Yeah,
then?
Yeah.
Oh, happy Veterans Day.
Man, no, I didn't do it like that. I didn't go to Vietnam, but I know people who did.
Okay.
On that note, whether you agree with the war thing or not, if you put on that uniform and you get back here, they ought to take care of your ass.
Well, they don't. Anyway, so my dad was a veteran, and my grandfather, yeah.
Yeah.
Where were you enlisted, buddy?
I was in the Navy.
Ooh,
yeah, I played basketball and tennis.
Okay, you know.
I want to say to all of the veterans out there.
No, you
stupid little motherfucker going out there fucking with that motherfucker. Them people ain't doing shit to you.
All right, anyway.
I knew he was going
to
come with
I'm just saying, them people ain't doing shit to you.
Sometimes that's just the only place to go.
To go fuck with other people that ain't fucking with you.
No, not even just that. Just
save your life.
Well,
save your life doing what?
Not even that, though.
You fucked up in high school.
Well, most of the people I know exactly. It's a place to get away.
You just barely graduated and you ain't.
And they don't know anything.
Either it's the Army or Foot Locker or
so you're basically saying the Army is for losers.
There's plenty of men
there. Not necessarily losers, but it gives a lot of people a lot of different opportunities.
That's right.
It gives them college opportunities. It gives them real estate opportunities.
So would you say it's an opportunity if you in the middle of Vietnam shooting at Vietnamese people and you a black man? Would you say that's an opportunity?
Well,
we're not talking about that.
Right.
And most of those, they didn't even enlist themselves.
What? Okay.
We just got to
be honest. If you're not this intellectual scholar and you're not, you know, colleges are looking for you and you're not a thought leader in the community, sometimes going to the Army or the Navy or the military
is a quick way out.
It just saves your fucking life.
Bobby, what did you tell me?
You're not going to do anything.
Bobby told me that the Vietnamese people had a speaker going one day. What was they saying?
They were saying, Buffalo Soldier, not your war. Because I had a cousin, George D. Osborne. He went to Vietnam in 67. And he got drafted, okay? And we used to communicate. He was my big brother, my hero. And when he was sending, you know, letters back to us, and then other people who came back from war told me what it was like over there, man. They said, man, they were sending out leaflets at night, and they had loudspeakers, Soul Brother, Not Your War, Soul Brother, Not Your War.
The Vietnam people were saying, what the fuck are you doing out here?
Yeah, it was,
people tell me that shit about the war, I mean, this is my opinion. Yeah. I'm like, you had no business there.
But here's what was worse than that, when they came back here.
Oh my God, it was horrible.
Because they
weren't
taking care of.
They still don't. And that's the real shame.
Veterans got it tough, man, when they come home.
They give you the thanks of a grateful nation and
a
parade.
That's why I'm putting it out there. I'm just saying
it's
exploitation.
Well, yeah, but at the same time, Corey, it is a way. Sometimes people just don't have any other out, and they look for it.
You cannot be proud of taking from someone else. That isn't, first of all, you were kidnapped and brought here, and then you were shipped somewhere else to take somebody else's land.
That's
you can't be proud
spot.
Of that.
Yeah.
You can't be, I'm not gonna sugarcoat it, and a lot of people get mad at me when I say stuff like this, but I'm just saying, I'm calling it out for what it really is.
The government definitely has to treat, its military and their servicemen better. And, a serviceman is just like the stereotypical police officer fireman. Mm. Those are looked at stereotypically and culturally as heroes. Mm. But if you treat your heroes like zeros when they get home, then that's a double standard that don't mean shit to the people you putting on the front lines, and your kids ain't on the front lines. And then you got the people who are enrolled in these different branches of the military who feel like, oh, my life was saved and this was a great thing. But at the end of the day, where are the services? When I see a bum who served, when I see somebody who can't get his medical
treatment,
benefits and all of that,
you
can't turn around and then say, okay, they heroes.
Right.
You're treating them like shit. So we have to understand that.
It's a big problem. All right,
well, got deep, darling.
No, but I didn't mean for that to get deep. I was actually, you spoke up before I can actually get that other little, I was going to get another little thing following right up there, right? Well, Big Bank Hank.
Who is that?
From the Sugar Hill Gang passed away this morning.
Bobby don't know who that is.
Bobby don't know who Big Bang Hank is.
No. Bobby remember the original Sugar Hill Gang. There was a Sugar Hill.
You know what?
And it was a gang protecting that shit.
A hill of sugar.
Right.
In Tennessee.
Right.
Bless his heart. He was only 57. And he was fighting cancer. So he passed away this morning.
Do you know what verse he sang in that song from the Sugar Hill Gang?
Big Bang Hank?
He started out?
He stole it.
He didn't start it out. He's second.
Oh yeah, wait a minute. Hip.
I'm the CAS.
Is that him?
That's him. And he stole his rhyme. He stole Casanova Love. He stole the dude's rhyme.
He just said his rap.
Oh well.
So, I don't know if you know about all that. That goes.
That's hip hop history.
Yeah, exactly. But anyway, he passed away. So that happened this morning.
Did you know him?
I met him a couple of times, but I didn't like know him really well. Okay. No, I know Melly Mel and Kaz and all them really well. But anyway, they had the Soul Train Awards this weekend, as you know, in Las Vegas. They had it on a Friday, which was really odd. That was interesting for people to get out there. And the biggest buzz happened to be the reunion of Jodeci. So you had all four members of Jodeci came out and they killed it. Thank goodness. It looks like they're back. Looks like they're all well.
What happened
that
to the one?
That paper got low. They like, fuck the bullshit.
They did. Somebody got in that
Let's
ass.
Make this CD.
They did. They did great. I thought they did really well, except for one of them falling. It was a slip. It wasn't because he was on anything. It just slipped. So that was great to see. Proud of those guys. And also the big buzz was Missy Elliott. Everybody was like, and I had already seen her a couple months before, but she lost a lot of weight.
She was thin?
She's very thin. I'll pull a picture up for you to see. But yeah, she looked great. The brat looked good. So they had like a reunion. So they performed. That was exciting.
Did the brat look like a girl or?
I'll show you a picture. She's very,
Big Cheryl
very,
from What's Happening.
Very womanlike.
Yeah, I like the
very
brat.
Nice.
I thought
she had
was
nice
always
corset
sexy.
On and everything. Yeah.
You remember
nice
that
body.
Little spread she put out when she had like when she dressed up like a girl and had the lingerie on? I was like, I will fucking impale the brat.
Kim came out. Lil' Kim came out as well, and she did some tweaking to herself, and she looks a lot better.
She did some tweaking and looks better for Darlene
to say she looks a lot better.
Well, no, because she had some surgeries that didn't work to me.
You bitches who catch them flights to them bullshit ass countries.
And it could have been
the
baby as well.
When they get through fucking you up out there, they be like, get the bitch out. We fucked that thing up.
It could have been having a baby as well. I don't know. Maybe it added.
Kim had a baby?
Yeah, he did.
Somebody fucked Little Kim with you that know, face?
Like, remember that? I think we spoke about it before Corey. When I said that Kim was...
Corey, somebody in the chat room said you got on a Missy Elliott sweatsuit.
But anyway, yeah, so she had a baby earlier this year. Yeah, she looks great.
We're going to talk about that for a second, but I want to say this about Missy Elliott. Even though Missy Elliott lost weight, I still would be scared to fuck with her for real because a bad 2 weeks, she'll be another fat bitch talking crazy to you at the crib.
Oh, God.
I'm just saying. Even though they get it together, even Jennifer Hudson, goddammit, I don't give a fuck what you have transformed into.
Jennifer
I
Hudson.
Know what can happen. Mm.
That body banging, though. Mm.
She's beautiful. Yeah, she got
God it. Damn, that body
she
banging.
She got herself real together.
When you get real fat like that, Darlene, does it stretch out your vagina?
No, what does the vagina have to do with anything?
Well, I'm saying, like, if she got fat, this skin pull up, too. So she got, like, one of them meat-hanging, meat-swinging vaginas because she lost a lot of weight.
No.
What do they go?
That's because, no.
Yeah, I know what he's talking about. It's the pastrami wallet.
Right. The pastrami wallet.
What does it do to guys, then, when guys lose a lot of that weight? Guys are the ones with the big stomachs.
Yo, pussy Jennifer Hudson right here. Oh.
Not listening to him. Not
damn
listening
it.
To him. I love him.
No, I'm saying,
no, but
like,
she bad now.
When guys are
well, if that's
get
the case,
big,
don't you know,
and they
you
lose
have sex
weight.
With a pregnant woman. I mean, they stretch out all the way out.
Right.
Okay,
pregnant pussy.
So,
pregnant pussy is
no,
the
I'm
best pussy
after.
In the world.
It's still the belly, so when it stretches out and it comes back, I mean, I've got a son. I weigh 200 pounds at the end of having my kid.
Really?
I gained 75 pounds in 9 months.
Wow. I like having sex with pregnant women because when you when you let loose in them, if you listen, you can hear the little baby say, motherfucker. Now, I don't know you, little motherfucker.
Turnips!
You got more? We love it, Dean.
I bet you do.
I love playing off with you, dude. She just look, she
I
goes and research this shit, and she be ready to have like some
I'm
real
like excited. I'm like, anyway, ladies, I didn't say that. I love and respect all those ladies. I love and respect all those ladies. Anyway, the
Luke
last
talk
thing,
about bullshit.
The last thing is kind of boring, but I thought it was kind of interesting and exciting. Yeah, a little bit.
Which
all right.
Is it
anyway,
now?
Okay.
God,
I don't know if you guys heard
excited?
About the new. I don't know if you heard about the new law that Obama's trying to regulate. Net neutrality. Mm-hmm.
Net
have you heard about neutrality?
About yeah.
Okay, so what it is, have you heard about this, Corey?
No.
Okay, he's trying to regulate, which makes sense to me. I would love that, where all these big companies, you know, you pay extra money to get, like, better service,
yes.
Better Wi-Fi, faster speed, things like that, right? And they get people with that. You know what I'm saying? Like, he wants to regulate it where if you turn it on, turn the service on or what have you, it's all the same, the speed, so internet. Because right now they're really ganking people for a lot of money. And so, but they're making jokes about it, calling it like, this is Obamacare for the internet. But anyway, he's trying to get this passed so that he can regulate that. I like it. I think it makes sense.
Uh-uh.
Why not?
Leave the motherfucking net alone.
I don't think so. No. Speed-wise, things
listen,
like that. No, it has
you,
to do with the...
If you allow one little piece of legislation to regulate the net, they're going to lock that motherfucker down. The net is the one place... Motherfuckers get to just piss off and say what the fuck they want, do what they want. The more they try to regulate it, the more...
So you're saying this is going to a starting off of something like that, getting
they,
that
they
point.
Don't never do no... This always chess with them.
Because
they not ever
because
trying to do some
how
shit
people
to help
can, they're
people.
Saying how people can't afford, because a lot of people can't even watch shows like this. Any type of show we're watching, the TV and things like that, because they don't have the proper speed.
I
they
know what
you're
saying, Darlene, and I, I'm not an Obama fan, but I agree with it. And I'm gonna say this: listen, we all know they're gonna fuck us. I mean, if they charge you extra for the internet that you are supposed to have,
right?
That, oh, but you
I mean,
you,
they
quality.
Should
right.
be locked up for that,
right?
You playing with people? That's immoral behavior. But I will say this: back to what Zoe said. Mm. It's all a setup, in my opinion.
It's the start. You're
okay,
right.
you're
start
doing that
like,
to do
I, it sounds
what?
Good.
That's what I'm saying.
Well, here's that saying. It ended like, it sounds good.
Right.
I don't know if that one, but it, anyway, it sounds good. So that's
sounds
it. I don't want to take too much over you guys.
It's
so,
like when question. You see a cute girl come out the clinic, you'll be like, I don't know about you, bitch.
What's the buzz in your community about this immigration thing? You know, he's pushing that he's going to use an executive order to
you know, mitigate the damage to people who are already in this country.
I don't know enough about it to speak on it by myself. I don't know.
Darlene ain't into that immigration shit.
Oh, stop. No, I don't. Right now, I don't know where it's at. All I know, though, is that I've been here 5 generations, my family, and my grandparents remember the day when it was built. And they were dragging folks. It was just like kind of like a hearsay, like, hey, they're dragging people back over to Mexico saying, hey, but they were here. Mm-hmm. They've always been here. They built, popped up a border and drug as many as they could over there and then shut it up.
So what you're saying, the people who stole this land from the Indians, who went to Africa and jacked us over here to make
it. All the same people, right?
Are basically telling the people of Mexico, you can't be here?
The ones who are already here.
So isn't
that's what happened in the beginning. You didn't know that court? Yeah.
That's a pretty common enemy to a lot of people.
Oh, yeah. We're all on the same.
And nobody has ever really taught it that way. You know what I mean?
Nope, exactly. Yeah, we're all like, exactly.
We're all victims of that fuck.
Uh-huh.
And we know who you are. I know who you are. You're a fuck. You have to play the separation game to pull this bullshit off your door.
Exactly. That's why I look at folks and I go, what are you guys all doing?
Yeah.
We're all in on this fight together.
They're laughing at something they saw in the chat room. What happened on the chat?
About the game.
Somebody.
I hope it's good.
Somebody on Twitter said, how you let Morgan Freeman's brother beat you?
Easy reader.
Oh, boy.
Anyway, So awesome. I don't, Bobby. I don't know exactly what they're doing right now with all that. If you ask my folks, like I said, my grandparents, people like that, they just be quiet.
So, as far as we just loose with the talk, Corey, how was it going home this past weekend to Chi-Town, man?
Oh, yeah, I went to Chi-Town.
Chi-Teasy.
You know, it is what it is. Chi-Town, they don't be phony with you. I have a very strong show.
Was it just you?
But I'm going to tell you something. I'm so used to people falling all out of chairs, jumping out the place.
Right.
So
right.
I still had it like that, but I'm talking about most of the place.
Right.
This time, Chi-Town was looking at me like, yeah, motherfucker, all right. You know what I mean?
Really?
It wasn't like that. It was a good show, but I'm just saying.
It's home. Like, yeah.
I'm so used to motherfuckers like rolling all out. Yeah, maybe it's my arrogance. Yeah. I'm like, hey.
And they know you.
Right. Y'all just laughing.
fall out.
Hey, that was funny, motherfucker. That wasn't regular funny. That was brilliant. But like I say,
that was brilliant.
I do a lot of bold jokes about the situation women are in with their illegitimate children.
Right.
And one day in Orlando, when I was in Miami, one show out of the 6 shows I did. I got that kind of response. Like, it was like shock.
Mm-hmm.
Like, how dare you talk about my illegitimate child?
Wow.
I'm here to say, bitch, you got more than one.
But I know the numbers was crazy.
We did good, man.
Yeah.
Who was on the bill? Yeah. Was it just you?
Me and DC Curry and Cheryl Underwood and Melanie Camacho.
Wow.
Y'all killed them.
Melanie Camacho did good, too. She rocked.
Melanie Camacho from here.
Yeah.
She put that makeup on, goddammit. People thought she was cute.
She's cute.
What you saying?
Funny.
That makeup saying Melanie is not cute?
I'm saying that makeup is fucking amazing.
You saying her makeup is fine?
Is Oprah Winfrey fine?
No.
Bam!
Her makeup is fine.
Right. That makeup.
Got pretty makeup.
That makeup is fucking amazing what it can do to a face.
Mm. Are you saying Melanie Camacho is ugly?
I'm saying.
I just need you to go on record.
This is what I'm saying. They have makeup now where they basically spray paint
Earl Shive
face. Yeah, they Earl Shive you a face.
It's called airbrush, yeah.
Airbrush.
It's like a little new face.
It doesn't matter. Listen, I didn't know. There's a billboard up for a sister she played on The Help.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know her name.
Mm-hmm.
Which one, Viola?
I think it's Viola. She has a show now.
I love her. That show is
There's a billboard.
So
saying Viola ain't cute.
I didn't know that was her on the billboard because she has had her face Earl Shive. Airbrushed.
Wait a second now.
I had to really look and be like, oh, that's her. She got that makeup
well,
on.
Well, now, in her case, though, you know she's got the, what is it, the alopecia, the
Vitiligo?
Vitiligo. She's got that. You know that, right? Really bad.
I didn't know
that.
What is that?
She's got it really bad.
So you mean they paint her chocolate and she's really a white woman?
No, she's got the patches, though. You can see it. I've seen it without, and without her hair. Yeah.
Have you seen the supermodel or the model girl with the vitiligo?
Yeah, and she's
fine
almost all taken over, too.
Really?
She's got patches all over herself. Yeah. She's fine as shit.
Yeah. All I'm saying is, what's her name, Viola?
Viola Davis.
Viola Davis. Yeah. If you had to be in a relationship with her because you financially strapped, and she took off them shoes and it wasn't right, I would just go on back out there in the street. That face and funky feet ain't gonna hurt.
Did anybody here see that movie about the white people?
Kevin Costner?
What's
no, which
one?
Oh, that one. Oh, the funny one.
What's
where they trying to be
funny.
Dear White
People. I heard it was dumb.
Dear White
silly.
People?
It's just silly. It's
did
just
you
like,
see it?
No, I saw the previews of it, though.
Oh, so none of us have seen it then.
But okay. Chris...
Oh, yeah, see.
I mean, like, I don't go see sucker shit. When I go to the show, goddammit, I don't go to the movies. Like, if I go to the movies, I won't, in all likelihood, I won't go with a girl. Because most girls want to see some sucker shit. Mm. Like,
I don't know.
What was the name of that movie that came out with Taraji and she was getting chased by old boy?
By Idris Elba.
See, and I didn't even
that's
see that.
Girls
wanna,
that's
Idris.
What girls want to see. And
I
when
didn't
I,
see
I
didn't see
when
movie.
I beat your I ass, you don't want to see it, bitch.
You know what?
That ain't fair.
Well, then, since we're speaking of movies, though, I can
when
recommend
when I beat your ass, you
Bird
don't
want to
see
with
it.
Michael Keaton.
Birdman with
what's
Michael
Keaton.
What's
yeah.
that about?
Oh. It's pretty deep. You just have to
is
go
it
check
killing
it.
In?
No. No.
Oh,
no.
Well.
Okay, well, Darlene be watching deep shit, though.
I do. Plus, I have crushes on both those guys in there.
Michael Keaton.
Oh, my God. The original Batman. And Ed Norton, ever since Fight Club.
Ed Norton.
Woo!
A lot of my viewers don't know who Ed Norton is. You can Google him.
Google him up, Fight Club with Brad Pitt.
Just a little guy. He does the same acting, the same. In every movie, he's that same guy.
I'll
he turns that,
that
character
guy.
Into a lot of people.
Who?
Ed Norton.
Yeah. Even when he was in the Hulk.
But yo, this is what's up. So we're here, and Bobby and Zoe played a one-on-one.
He sure did.
And you know what? We found out that whatever Bobby is doing, because he always got this water that he tries to give you in an undesirable container.
Why do you say, you know? Go into that.
Well,
why do you think it's an undesirable container? What happened? What did Bobby give you?
Bobby offers water in jugs that little kids look like they caught goldfish in at the lagoon. When he gives you the water, you look at it, you be like, what a fish. It looked warm.
Why don't you get your machine fixed, man?
Bobby sold me a machine that he has. Have you ever been back to service
it
or show me how to service it?
I tried.
How long ago? Get the fuck out of here. How long ago did I buy
it?
How long ago did I buy it?
3 years ago.
Probably more than 3 years ago. But anyway, maybe 3 years ago. But
I told you to go get it tonight and we'll get you back on that machine, bro.
I don't know about this water, but I'll tell you this. Bobby was moving like he was on something. I know he smoked squares. And
I'm
going to
tell you what Bobby was on.
I expected Bobby to die tonight. I'm just giving you a
I'm
going to
tell you what Bobby was on. Bobby has a cocaine addiction.
He
don't want to tell nobody.
Oh, my God.
We are going to play the game at the end of the show. And I want... When we play this game at the end of the show, I want everybody to just remember Bobby is 60 years old.
Yeah.
Wait till you see the energy Bobby has.
Yeah.
But back on the serious note.
He looked great, though. Nah, he looked great.
Back on the serious note, Bobby... does something obviously to take care of himself, and I wanted to talk about taking care of yourself,
right?
Because you know what I'm saying, like I'm on the go a lot,
and
my discipline is at zero. I'm always running. From as soon as I get out the bed, I don't stop until I'm just so tired I lay back down. And I know it's a destructive lifestyle because I'm not only just doing this. You know what I'm saying? At home, I get on a lot of planes. And you know what I'm saying? It's like when I land a lot of times, I can't go to sleep because I got to go do the radio.
Right.
And everything.
Yeah.
So by the time I go to sleep, then I got to wake up early in the morning and go to the radio the next day.
Yeah.
So I might get some sleep like 2 days after I take a red eye out of town.
Mm.
And anybody who's taking a red eye from Los Angeles knows you're basically leaving at about 2 or 3 in the morning on the East Coast. So you can land at about 6 or 7. It's just like being in another country.
Next day, your whole next day is gone.
When you fly from LA, it's like being in another country. So I know my body is telling me, hey, Corey, you need to get a hold of yourself.
Real quick.
And try to catch back up on the things that you know you used to do and enjoy, like being athletic,
like playing hoop,
doing things like that. Because I see myself, I got bigger. So today I want to talk about not just what somebody can do, but the rigors of life will make you fall off to the point where you feel like you can't get back right. Because I got a lot of friends that have just, I say, man, you gave up.
That's the problem.
When you see them, you're like, wow, man, you had got a little weight on you, but now you're an obese person. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? You won't fight it. Mm. And, you know, like in this first segment, I would like to talk about what happens to people when they give up. Mm. Maybe there's something we can say that will help people wake up tomorrow and say, you know what? What those guys said made sense. I've let myself go to the point where, you know what I'm saying? I feel like I'll never be able. Really, people feel like I'm just going to die. I'm just going to wilt away.
Right.
Man, you just said a mouthful right there, Corey. Yeah. Simply because.
We got a brother on the mic
that
everybody, we need to introduce. I'm sorry, everybody. Right. I didn't introduce him sooner. Mm-hmm.
Bobby, they said he was
Bobby
my brother. Father.
I'll let. He's what?
They said that's Zoe's daddy.
Either that.
I thought he was with Darlene at first. Yeah. Darlene. I was like, damn, Darlene.
You know.
I want to introduce everybody to my father. I haven't seen him since 1978.
I'll let Bobby.
Welcome back to my life, daddy.
Okay, go ahead.
All right, brothers and sisters, this is Ed Martin. And I met Ed 8 years ago through a brother by the name of Adonijah. And Ed introduced Adonijah to the water. And Adonijah was
what water?
Kangen water. Kangen water. Kangen means return to origin in Japan. But more importantly, the brother's spirit and his knowledge was so proper that I later found out that in addition to being up on how to take care of the body, I found out he was one of the most dangerous human beings on the planet Earth. This brother used to head up security for Diana Ross. He's worked with princes from Saudi Arabia and whatnot. This brother can literally touch you and end your life.
I believe you. Let me tell you something. Want me to tell you how I know that? Because I didn't put it together. But when a person is really quiet, that's when I'll be like,
what's up with him? Who is that, mama?
Somebody is quiet. I want to let all y'all out there know. When motherfuckers are quiet, it's because they done fucked up so many people. They trying to give you a chance.
They decide whether they should kill you or not.
When they quiet, they try not to say nothing because they don't want to have to fuck you up. Remember that.
Hey, motherfucker was telling me some shit on the way up here.
Right.
About his training and...
He's on another level.
When a motherfucker tell you, Bruce Lee, he aight. What?
That's what's up. Some brother like
that. Damn.
For somebody who has, you know, gotten to the point in their lives, in their life, where they are obese, but they weren't obese, you know what I'm saying, when they were coming up, like in high school, college.
Yeah, right.
They got obese as they got older. Is there anything you could tell them just starting off? Like, because, you know, people listen who are obese and feel like, but there's no way, after a while, you know, it becomes repetitive from the people they know. So sometimes a stranger can tap something in their ear that might change their life.
Absolutely. The thing that has to be considered at all times is how we speak to ourselves. Because we have to understand that we are a spiritual entity that incarnated into a human body. And once we are incarnated into a human body, we access the brain, which accesses the rest of the body through the nervous system. So that brain has a subconscious, and that subconscious is there to protect us, serve us, or destroy us based on how we speak to ourselves and how we perceive ourselves, or we perceive the world around us. The first thing we have to do is create the will, meaning that we have to speak to ourselves. which is what prayer or meditation really is. We're speaking to the power of our own consciousness. And when you establish in your mind the definitive decision that no more, from now on, this is what it is, that is what it's going to be. But you have to create the will, the desire to make that change and just keep that vision.
So like for a person who works you know, a lot of hours during the week.
The law of causality.
Yeah,
Meaning what we do has an effect. What we say will cause an effect. So in other words, you have to determine what it is that you want to accomplish, what it is that you want for yourself, for your body, for your life. And then once you map out that programming, meaning that you're going to make certain decisions, and once you map that out, you still have to instruct yourself in the will that this is what I want to do, this is what I'm going to do, and it's going to be starting now. And that affirmativeness, that is what's needed. Because wishful wishing, you know, I would like to, it all depends on how we speak to ourselves. I would like to lose weight. So I would like to exercise.
Let me ask you this. Corey is struggling right now. He's looking like a silver water balloon right now. So how is his big ass going to access this spiritual shit you're talking about? He wants to know, what should he do when he sees that glazed donut at 2:30 in the morning in the airport? What should he do? This motherfucker's struggling like Pookie. Help him.
Well, Zoe said that for me, but it's not necessarily knowing. I mean, obviously, someone sense knows what's right and what's wrong when they're eating something that's not going to help them out. But what I'm saying is, like, there's just a lot of people out there who are, I mean, like, what comes on television, the way they are talking on television, I talked about this before, it goes over their head because they're not listening to people who they can't relate to.
Right, right.
This show, we normally have people that, you know,
they can relate to. Yeah,
yeah. These guys in the chat room who act silly and everything.
We fucking love them.
Most of them are listening to what we're saying.
Yeah.
And we're talking the language they can understand. Yeah. That's why I'm glad that we got somebody on here who, you know what I'm saying, they can relate to.
Right. Because
I believe on television, a lot of times, people just can't relate to the folks that are allowed to speak on television.
That's true. Well, no, that's true.
The first
that's
trigger true. That we had to deal with is, we're bombarded around the clock with these messages, and they call it comfort food. The real thing that's got to happen for people to regain control of their bodies is to understand what works in their bodies and what works against their bodies. Because with, you know, you watch these commercials, and it's this real sexy person who's drinking a soda, or they're eating something.
Skinny bitch eating a giant hamburger.
It's like, that ain't what they eat no way.
Right.
First of all. But it's like Serena. I've seen Serena with that sports drink. That ain't what Serena drinks. Okay. She's fighting, and if she gets to the point where she doesn't discipline herself, she's gonna blow up later on.
You can see how she's built.
Yeah, I know.
She doesn't make
she's a brick house right now.
Yeah.
But
oh my God, she gonna
those depression years which kick in.
The depression years,
man. I'm saying it's
the depression
people,
years. Tell
the
us.
Years where you're not the shit anymore.
No, where your metabolism
you're not
is just
the
stopped.
Shit anymore.
Yeah, man.
The depression years.
It hits you.
Darlene
like a
is a perfect example of surviving the depression years.
That's true.
I mean, like, I say that because even though now she's still an attractive woman.
Yeah.
Well, geez, thanks.
She had to make that adjustment when she found out that guys are like, hey, can you get out the way so I can look at the younger girl? It happened.
It's life. It's a cycle of life.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Right.
Hey.
Those are the depression years.
Oh, God.
When you're not the shit anymore.
Well, to some, Corey, to some.
God damn.
You're still the shit, huh, D?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying I don't really let much faze me. There's not much that phases me. I've been through too much.
Good for
seen
you.
A lot of death, things like that. I'm like, what really matters? So things don't usually faze me. But something that triggered right now, what Bobby just
play that song Colors right now.
Shut your ass up.
You know.
What you said Because that's what I do. I'm a fitness instructor. I do group X. And something that he just said, because a lot of people...
Group some, sex?
What? Group X.
Oh. That's what's that?
Exercise. Just classes. Be clear. You instruct classes. You don't do one-on-one.
It's when a lot of people are in a class in taking class instruction together, yeah. from you.
Corey, you took one of my classes, by the way, but you yeah. tried it. Yeah.
She had a lot of guys in there who aren't interested necessarily
in the class.
No, they didn't. No.
Did she do a lot of bending?
If you got a banging ass body, you can get this paper and some tights.
Anyway.
Bending over fast. Bending up fast. I'm just fucking
with But anyway, something that Bobby hit on that resonated with me is what works for each person. See, because you can't look at me, people say, oh, but I bet you she has this regimen on her diet. This is not. So don't follow me. That's what I'm saying. Don't go, okay, well, look what she's eating. That works. I'm going to try it. It's not that. I know what works for me, and I know my routine. I know right. that I can have this, and then still I'm about to burn it off the next day.
But you know
or I can enjoy this. I don't eat like that. A lot of people think that I stick to a certain particular diet. I'm like, do not but you follow me around. And
darling, you're a meat eater.
Hell yeah, I am.
But you know
yeah.
what I think? I think it's impossible, virtually impossible, nothing's impossible, mm-hmm. virtually impossible to get nutrition in America. Good nutrition.
Good nutrition. It's a lot of work.
You got to supplement.
It's
got to
work
do some
and
shit.
It's a lot of money for yes. most people.
It's a but, lot but of bread.
Listen, listen guys, listen, let me say this.
Can't be done cheap.
There's a lot of people
try,
who don't know.
You ain't going to enjoy it.
There's a lot of people who don't know what supplement means who are watching this show right now. Can somebody tell the listeners, the viewers, what you mean when you say you have to supplement?
Basically, you have to give the body the building blocks it needs. You have micronutrients, which are your vitamins, your minerals.
Where do they get them? In the food?
You can. That's
you
the
can,
best way.
You can, but it's very difficult it's because farming technologies right now deplete
crazy.
The soil mm. of nutrients.
Did you hear that, 5150? Farming nutrients. So basically, I think what this brother is trying to say is the shit you buy at the store is set up to fail your body.
That's correct.
Ooh, good point.
Very good point.
Yeah. Well, when the motherfuckers say food stuff.
They ain't bullshit.
They not bullshit. It ain't food. Real food. Food
it's
stuff.
Food.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But here's the truth of the matter. Finish your point, then I'll mm-hmm. add to what I'm
The other factor is the macronutrients, your proteins, your carbohydrates, and your essential fats.
Hmm.
And don't sleep on your fats. You got to have your fats because mm-hmm. they are essential.
Avocados, my favorite.
Omega 3, 6, 9s, all of those.
No, monounsaturated, mm-hmm. polyunsaturated. Yeah. If you look
Hang
at
there,
olive oil,
yeah.
that is a perfect blend of the monounsaturated, polyunsaturated, and saturated
But you know
fat.
What black people do? Black people will take some olive oil and fry some chicken with it.
Nothing wrong with that.
But
nothing wrong with the olive oil, but most of the people
if you
don't
do
use
it too much.
No, but they'll use the
much,
wrong
olive
oils.
Oil fuck you up too. You can't fry no goddamn chicken in olive oil.
It's expensive as hell.
It's expensive.
Anyway, so they ain't gonna do it anyway.
That'll clog you up too.
No, it won't.
It won't.
Those are
essential fats.
Meaning your body. Yeah. If you don't feed your body essential fats, you will die.
You trying to tell me if you fry some chicken and some olive oil, first off, fried foods in and of themselves ain't some good shit you should be eating anyway.
Mm-hmm. No, well, everybody know you can't eat fried foods every day.
Not every day.
You fry some chicken and some motherfucking olive oil, I think some shit's going to happen to you.
But it's the best way to fry chicken, right?
No, here's the thing. When you say fried,
mm-hmm.
most people fry or used to fry what? Lard?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, canola, vegetable. Oh,
right. Exactly. See that's bad.
Pig
that's
Vaseline.
Bad
that's bad. That's what lard is. It's pig Vaseline.
But see, let me tell you something. When you were younger, Bobby, you mm-hmm. got a point.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. See, a lot of this depends on how radical a change a person really needs and how bad they really want to live. Because some people's body's not going to tolerate eating fried foods and losing weight. The two don't go together.
Right.
But if you want to live, you may need to have a radical change in your diet. It may become necessary. And I can speak to this because I had to make certain decisions about what I ate. I grew up in the South. We fried everything. Everything. And we still do eat like that to a certain degree. But if you want to have a certain amount of health, you have to make some choices. Do you want to live or do you want to sit up and eat yourself to death?
They said Corey, niggas in the chat room said Corey eats fried Snickers.
Right, yeah, I saw that.
It's funny all the way to the graveyard for some people, you know, yeah. But in truth, the other brother that we will eventually have on another show that deals with health, we have to learn that there are options. People can grow food locally, literally, they don't even have a yard. You know, you can grow food in pots and stuff right off your balcony and whatnot.
Man, motherfuckers will piss. Piss on your food, goddamn it! If you got a lot.
Hey, but to go back to Corey's point. Mm. Start growing some shit. See, don't they come see you?
Well, come on.
Who is they?
Yeah.
We always say this.
Come on.
Motherfuckers start getting regulated for the shit they come do on, in their own
oh,
houses.
Oh, yeah, they'll be like, you're not allowed to do that.
You're not allowed zoning and all this. They'll come up with all kinds of shit.
Come on, then.
That will try to prevent you from doing what, you know, well, like, that's oh, I want to have a garden where I produce my
the
own.
The lady who does the teeth cleaning for me, what she does, she has a couple of chickens.
Mm-hmm. My dad has
and
chicken.
She,
yeah,
she, you know, when she was telling me about how
free
she,
range.
Yeah, she basically gets her own eggs from the chickens. Mm-hmm. I never thought of stuff like that being an inner city guy. And what I'm saying is, listen, man, I come from a place where most people, when they're hungry, they go to the chicken shack around the corner.
Right. Mm.
Most people, I come from a place where they're hungry. It's gotten to the point where the family structure is so far gone.
Mm-hmm.
Eating a meal that was cooked at home in the stove
is
something that happens on holidays.
It's rare.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah.
Rare.
Mm.
Very rare.
So what I'm saying is making everybody aware of, because obviously you know why you got weight on you, but do you realize that your way of life
is
not the way you're supposed to be living? And that's what I'm trying to get across to people.
That's a great point, Corey, because a lot of why I'm able to be active now is I grew up in an era where we produced our own food locally, okay, and we were athletic, we were energetic, we played sports all the time, year round, we were active. And, you know, believe it or not, we had to chop wood and do all kind of stuff just to live.
I felt
now,
that shit today.
You on fairground?
Him and Rooster, all of them.
The fairgrounds is here right now.
But, you know, then you got to go to 24-hour fitness and all of that. But, see, a lot of people don't realize, man, you can exercise right in your house. I
felt the
no
wood
gym,
chopping
man.
Today, Bobby.
You know.
Well, I tried to go up for a layup, nigga, damn near threw me on the ground.
Bobby is saying you can exercise in your house.
In your house, man. And walk to the store. I see people get in their car, man, and drive around.
Well, we live a very sedentary life in America.
It's crazy.
Hey, man, there are people who live in places, neighborhoods, where when you walk to the store,
you might get
shit could jump off.
Shit could go all bad, right?
I'm putting this stuff in everybody's head because I'm trying to show the world that there are a lot
how
of obstacles
that and there's options
are in front of you.
You can stand in front of that TV that you can't miss that next commercial with and just shadow box for 2-3 minutes, man.
I know a guy who works here with us, this kid named Mike. This motherfucker more bullshit than anybody I know.
Mm-hmm.
It's just it hasn't kicked in on him yet because he's a young man.
That
I think
metabolism.
He's 22.
Yeah.
Right.
23 years old.
Enjoy it because when you slow down,
right.
You got a hummingbird metabolism now.
Catch up with you, man.
And you know, and when we come back from break, that's what I'm gonna try to give some ideas on what you can do.
Right.
To try and stop the routine that you have built.
There you go.
And you don't really realize this routine is bad until you get
old
and sick.
Because
you get old and sick now. And I'm not talking about 80 years old and sick. I'm talking about 40 years old.
It's worse than that. You got kids that are on medication in grammar school, man.
Yes, yes. Because of the routine.
It's crazy,
and maybe something we could say about the routine can give somebody something to think about to change that.
So don't let them put your kids on medication.
Ever.
And when we come back,
that's a crime.
Bobby's gonna have a new look.
Yeah, when we come back, we're gonna talk about that. And
go
I guess
to the car, man.
Bobby got a new look.
He got a new look
because Bobby he has not worn the tank top the whole show, and he was supposed to wear it as he lost. Anyway, 5150 show. We'll be back.
Like you're say, welcome.
Live a life that you enjoy instead of just getting money and then feeling bad.
I got to reply to that.
Okay. All right.
That's good. Your game's already set up.
5150 show. We are back from break. Bobby went and changed into his tank top that has soiled quite a bit since the game.
Oh yeah,
man. He smelled like he about to ask me something. Yeah. Only thing missing is the bus stop. Dope Fiend 5150 action. See, he put the hat on too with the tank top too.
Panhandler Records presents.
He looked like one of them dudes washing your windshield in Atlanta at the gas station. hey, man, want me walk that windshield for you?
I'll take it.
And they make it worse. They just smear and stuff. Right.
Hey, man. It's all good.
You know, we talking about, you know, health, man, and fitness. You know, the want-to part of it is important, man. I mean, you know, you get to a stage in your life where you say, well, damn, man, am I ever going to feel good again? You know, and a lot of people don't. They just get out of bed, man, and they get through the day. They start taking that medication, man. Then they can't shit, you know, and you can see it on their face, man.
What about metabolism, Bobby? Do you think metabolism plays a large part
in
what's happening?
No.
So you think some people are just obese because they eat a lot?
No, it's not just that they eat a lot. It's the thing that they consume in addition to eat. Milk does not do the body good. That's some bullshit. Sodas, man, look, that's cancer in a can.
Listen, man, I've been sucking on a cow tit since I was little.
Yeah.
Milk does a body good.
No, it don't. Why did they say that in the commercial, Bobby?
I believe what the commercial says.
Zoe, do you drink soda?
All the goddamn time.
Okay. You see what I'm saying, Bobby?
But it's not good for me.
Can you keep it up, though?
We know it's not good for you, Zoe. But Zoe,
can you keep
Zoe
it up?
Zoe is at an age.
Are you gonna be drinking sodas when you're 60?
Hell nah. No, you know what I do though. I'm aware that the shit is horrible, but I ain't gonna lie. That sugar is cocaine, and I'm pookie. So what'll happen is I'll be aware because I'll pick up some pounds because I done drank some fucking sodas for 2 weeks. Mm. But then I'll say, fuck that. I make myself go like 3-4 months without drinking it.
Zoe's a perfect example of what I'm talking about. One day we went to Buffalo Wild Wings.
Was I there?
You were there. Uh-huh. Bobby, you were there? We met up with
Guy Black. I was about to say, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Zoe ordered a big-ass hamburger. I remember.
Yeah. At Buffalo Wild Wings?
What else did you order, Zoe? Because I watch what you eat.
I ordered a hamburger and some, I guess, some wings or some other shit. But at that time,
huh?
I think I ordered some. I remember slightly, but it was a big-ass burger. But I ordered a couple of things. But at that time, I was active than a motherfucker. I was still balling. See, I ain't played ball till tonight. Shit, it's been about 4 months. Mm.
The point I'm trying to make is this. There are people who don't watch their diet, but they don't gain weight like that.
Yeah.
Well, there are people who actually don't eat a whole bunch of bullshit, but everything they eat piles on them.
Right.
Now, there's not a doctor in here that can explain this, but the point I'm trying to make is some people just are fortunate enough to have the type of metabolism where weight doesn't pile on them fast.
Well, if you're not one of those people, then Nash, it's time to make a decision. If you know that you consume certain things and put on weight, then you're going to live till you die, and it's going to be an abbreviated life for that very reason.
Now, Bobby, listen. You are talking a good one. I'm just letting you know.
Oh, I was going to say something.
But I know you smoke. How much do you smoke, Bobby? Tell the truth.
I smoke probably 10, 15 cigarettes a day.
Yes. Okay.
I was going to say something.
That is my dad,
but you know
I don't.
No, it's not.
Answers.
I know how many cigarettes I smoke a day.
You don't expect nobody who smokes to tell you how many they smoke.
Sometimes
I know that. That's
like
why I didn't say nothing.
Nicotine cologne.
But what you need to ask me is what else I do, though, to smoke.
You can't work off smoke. But look,
this
is what
I'm trying
to say. You can't
work your lungs off. Not the pictures I've seen of charred lungs.
This is what I'm trying to say.
You can't work off smoke.
Darlene, let me ask you your opinion on this, because you know a little bit about, you know, this, that, and other. A bad diet versus cigarettes. Which is worse?
I think a bad diet.
Bad diet, because you can always change from that. A lot of times when people stop smoking, they can you can't ever recover the damage that was already done to your lungs. Because
the game I just played against this old motherfucker proves to me that a bad diet is worse than cigarettes, because this motherfucker gave me all that I could handle.
Yeah, but for how long?
I had to dig deep. I had to think about my dead mama. Like,
yeah, but that was like 15, 20-minute games, but I'm talking about the long haul, like stamina, the breathing.
Okay, I got to say this, and I ain't trying to start no shit, but I give Bobby all the credit in the world for playing a good game because he's 60 years old. But so I didn't say this, and people will watch this at the end of the game. You got a very finesse game.
Oh, yeah.
You are not a workhorse. See, if Bobby played me, he wouldn't have finished the game.
I could have took Bobby into the paint. I just didn't want to.
A lot of people say what they could have did.
That first move, I think he got scared too, though.
When I was at the All-Star game, but I didn't.
Wait a minute.
Bobby, I could have took you in the paint. Do we have to do it again?
Oh, yeah?
Oh, shoot.
We do the shit again.
Here we go.
See, Zoe is trying to act like he held back. Did you hold back, Zoe?
I shot all jumpers.
No, you couldn't get to
the
hole.
That's the thing, man.
He's going to let you go.
That ain't
Bobby, you
fair,
can't
man.
Let me do nothing.
Okay, we need to
go. That ain't fair, Zoe.
You know, like, Zoe, I let you do a goddamn thing,
so,
Bobby.
You basically saying you held back on Bobby.
Nah.
I held back on Bobby.
That's some bullshit.
Because I respect my elders.
No, you had to get out. It was 5-5.
Bobby,
right.
That shit was listen, up for grabs, nigga.
I got a terrible jump shot. My jump everybody shot is broke, and that's what beat you.
Nah, your jump shot.
My
was
son crazy. Calls me.
Oh my God.
What?
This is what my son calls me. He goes, Dad, your jump shot is terrible. You're like a. He said you're. A, he said he
man,
called me.
One of them lucky ass
he called me a six. He pulled. Called me a 6 foot. A 6 foot 1'4".
Okay,
said,
now let me
four.
Say this.
You're a power.
Zoe,
forward.
You can respond to this, and if anybody else who was there agree with me, please let me know. When you tried to go to the hole, Bobby showed you. Bobby showed you some strength.
He did.
He let you know that it ain't sweet like that.
He did.
There was defense.
And I knew it was coming.
That's what I'm saying.
I knew it was coming.
So
and no question.
I think you didn't go to the hole.
I could go to the hole though.
No,
this
no,
is my
no,
opinion. No. I think you wasn't going to the hole.
Did Bobby
because
even
Bobby that. Showed you.
Did Bobby even
it
get
ain't
to
sweet
the,
like that?
Did Bobby even get to the basket?
No, I couldn't. I couldn't get to the basket.
Did Bobby even get to the basket?
No, okay. You had your elbow right where it's supposed to be.
Bobby,
you
I was being like hey, Roger Bobby
trigger.
Zoe was a very intelligent man. Yeah.
I was D'ing Bobby's ass up.
Every once in a while, we see Zoe dodge questions.
What am I dodging?
He gets louder, you Corey.
I'm saying, I feel like you didn't go to the hole.
Somebody said, Zoe's son calls him mom. Fuck all
somebody
you bitch
say,
ass niggas.
Zoe goes deep in the bank.
Anyway, Zoe swallows whole bananas.
I'm not taking nothing away from either one of these guys, but I saw when Zoe went to the hole, Bobby was strong enough to make it where he couldn't just walk him
no,
to the
it ain't
hole.
Easy.
That's what I said.
No, absolutely. It ain't easy. But I could, if
no,
I wanted to.
You tried to go to the hole through that shit on the other side of the backboard because it was.
And then what'd you do? You gave me the ball because you knew you fouled me. That ain't true.
What else is what I'm supposed to do?
They going to see it on the goddamn screen.
In the game I saw, shit. Both of them were gentlemen. They yeah. weren't trying to yeah. make it a wrestle
nah,
fest.
Didn't turn
they
it
gave up the foul.
That's
right,
true.
Right, right.
Once again, I say this. I think Zoe didn't go to the hole because he realized Bobby was more of a handful than
first
you thought
off,
he was going to be.
Yeah, yeah, now, Corey, yeah, yeah, yeah. Didn't you slip and fall going after the ball?
It will be seen on
we
video.
We was out there.
I was embarrassed because I was. Look, I can't even. When y'all see that part, that's toward the end of the game. I fell on my ass.
Hey. We out there
to get the
playing.
Ball.
Two old motherfuckers is out there playing on the ice skating concrete.
Yeah, it was.
Get the
yeah.
fuck! I ain't finna go
slippery.
In the paint.
It was slippery.
Hell no! Nah. Yeah. And I told you, we go in the gym is a different level.
Oh, okay.
For both well,
for,
not just your ass.
First off, we saw the finger roll air balls in the warm ups.
That was warm up.
God damn it! You can't have double. Come on now.
He ain't played in 4 months.
I got there a little late because I had to go buy the basketball. Somebody shot a finger roll air ball.
Yeah,
it was
yeah.
Bobby.
A couple of them.
But he didn't tell me about the time I cuffed him, though, and switched hands, though, and laid it up like
Bobby, you cuffed it and switched hands?
First off, Bobby was doing all this shit.
We had footage of
this? Yeah, they got it. Bobby was doing all this shit at 2.5 miles an hour.
The borrowed ball. The borrowed ball that he called the woolly mammoth. It was all
I never seen live action slow motion. He was doing all this shit. Smoking a motherfucker.
Well, let me say this. I haven't been playing basketball, but y'all was both too little to play against me.
I know what you're talking about.
You built like Big Bank Hank, nigga.
I told you, I'm from Chicago, and I would have been
Big Baby Davis.
I would have been housing you little motherfuckers. I'm like,
you ain't get the ball back. Are you going to shoot to you, man?
Dude, we been a fight.
No, but Bobby said the right thing. When we walked off that motherfucking court, he was like, nigga, we both winners because we didn't get hurt up.
That's
my
true. Yeah.
Bobby,
that's one of them courts.
Bobby made it a competitive game in the Skechers that came with roller skates. he took the roller skates off the Skechers.
He took the
wheel. Did have on some low tops.
Damn.
Bobby was nimble out there.
Yeah, he was. He, you know, motherfucker's awesome.
With that health issue, man, as funny as we can make it, man, the serious part about it is it's within your grasp. You know, you just got to decide, man, what kind of life do you want to live, man? You know, because I got friends of mine that are my age and younger, and I'm telling you, man, it's sad to watch them, man, because they think that they can go to their doctor and get a fix for
that. Tell them about that medication, Bobby. What does it do to you?
Man, that medication, it kills your sex drive.
Yeah, there's no easy fix.
It kills your sex drive.
I hate when I hear these people going, there's no easy fix.
It kills your sex drive.
So let me ask you a question. It's my man on the end. Do you feel like if you are an obese man, you still don't have it bad as an obese woman, your opinion?
No.
He's a gentleman, and I put him on the spot because I'm just creative like that. He's a gentleman. He doesn't want to say that. Go ahead.
I think women feel the pressure more than men.
Mm-hmm.
Just because.
So, yes, it is harder on a woman. I believe so.
I agree with that answer 100% because I have gotten weight on me, but I get them hoes.
I was going to say an obese man with paper, they going to fuck with him.
God damn it. I done seen Rick Ross out in the club.
With paper. They don't have to have paper now, though.
What else can an obese man use to get women?
What do you mean?
You said they don't have to have paper.
Charm.
Charm?
Yeah.
Charm will get you girls.
The guy I dated the longest is a city worker.
Who? Hey, Ice-T?
Hey, Ron.
She call it Ron. Ron.
Ron,
what's up?
Ron.
How old are you? You was with Ice-T for 32 years. That fucker's a vampire.
So she dated somebody longer than that.
Huh? God damn.
How long was Ron tapping that ass?
Shut up. He was not. No.
Yes, he
was. No, 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 no.
You dated somebody for a long time.
Look at that face. Look at that face.
I Wait, swore on everything. Yeah,
look at her face. You done bust that out on something.
No, no. He had kids that played baseball, and so did my kid. They played baseball together.
Wait, get her face on the camera.
No, this
is priceless.
No, you know I don't talk about that, though, so I don't go there. You really? Might have all these other girls that think it's exciting to talk about who they sleep with and what they do. I don't do that.
So you don't kiss and tell. We understand
that. Yeah, I don't
that.
Like that.
That's because
so
she's a lady.
I don't like that.
She's a real lady. Y'all should take
you
notes.
You out the shot. Get over here.
Oh.
You out the shot. Hold on.
No. But
y'all
no,
should
he,
take notes.
She in the shot?
He's like,
zoomed in. Okay.
Anyway, no, he's in his late 50s, mid-50s, late 50s.
How long have you been dating him?
Off and on for probably 7 years, huh? What's his love like?
Let's get the numbers right, because
right.
That shit might overlap into the Ice-T world.
Right.
Let's get the numbers right.
What do you mean? I haven't been with him for 13 years. I've been with my ex for 13 years.
He ain't been with Ice for 13 years. Okay, so good. We just wanted to get the number. We're doing
no,
the math.
It's been a long time. Are you kidding me?
Okay, good.
Yeah, no, he left when the kid was 10.
Look at this. We just want to get the number.
He left when our son was 10.
We just trying to add the numbers up.
All this stuff will be in the book.
Exactly. Thank you.
The new book, ladies and gentlemen, is called
Definition of Down.
Definition of Down. I like that.
Definition of Down.
What would it take for you to radically change your diet?
Probably just being able to just get away from everything I have to do for about 2 months. Sometimes I wish I just had 2 months with nothing to do so I can get back in
the whirlwind
of doing right. But when like, okay, tomorrow morning, I got to get up. I got this to do. I got that to do. I say to myself, I'll be done like at around about 8 o'clock at night. You know what I mean?
No, that's like, that's meanwhile, a good point. Yeah,
if right. I haven't planned out what I'm going to eat, when my body gets hungry, I'm going to stop and get something to eat somewhere. And that's what's messing me up every time.
And that's what's interesting about what this brother is saying. Nutrition is an ordeal. It's a plan. Mm-hmm. It's some shit. Just like you got all this other shit to do, nutrition has to be some of the shit you got to do.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Right? And if and the way you're describing it, you doing all this other shit, and instead of having time mapped out for your nutrition, right? Mm-hmm. You just, well, fuck it, I'm gonna grab this, I'm gonna do this, just so I'm not hungry. And that's causing more detriment than it is good, mm-hmm. because you don't have a planned out nutrition.
Yeah.
That's right.
So I say this 100%. Yeah. When I was a gym rat, broke, mm-hmm. it was the best time of my life.
Right.
When I was a motherfucker, just used to get up and go hoop every day.
I remember those days.
I didn't even have a car. I used to have to ride my bike to the gym, bicycle to the gym.
You was fit.
But it was the best time of my life. So now when I go to the gym and I see guys at the gym mm-hmm. who are there literally every time I go, I say to myself, wow, for most folks, mm-hmm. you almost have to make a choice. Which one you gonna do?
Right, right.
Putting it all together is not easy.
Right.
In fact, I would say it's difficult with the way the rat race goes now.
Well,
especially when you have a job. I'm not making excuses for me.
I'll tell
you
why.
I'm not saying that, but my job does not have hours that are set.
Right. Now, that's the key. I tell you, you said it right there.
I don't have a routine as far as it go with my job.
So
I'm up.
So let me give you this.
In the middle of the night. Because I'm in fucking butt fuck Buffalo.
So let me give you this, Corey. A lot of people who talk, and maybe you can speak to this too, who talk that there's not enough time in the day, right?
I don't think that's the case.
Right. A lot of times, but a lot of people will say that because they're trying to fit things in as they're doing it. That's because they don't have their calendar or their life mapped out to a calendar. First off, the most busiest motherfuckers in the world. I mean, skyballers. If you break their week down, it's 168 hours in a week. They have their whole life mapped out. Everything is mapped out. Those guys still have 30 hours left, 38 hours, 40 hours left from the 168 hours in the week. The average person who is nowhere near as busy as those people have 60, 70, 80 hours left in their week. So it's about mapping out your life. If you can map out your life, you can find time to have the nutrition that you need. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. It's just about taking control of the time you have, because that's the one thing, that's the one currency you can never get back.
I agree 100%, Zoe, and I want to say that might be a breakthrough for a lot of people. Maybe we need to have a show one day where you can show people who, because trust me, it sounds easy, mm-hmm. but it's not. But maybe one day we can put together a show where you can show people how to map out their week mm-hmm. according to the hours they work.
Yeah.
Corey, you brought up a good point, which was really what you were saying is that if we wait until we're hungry, we're going to get that impulse to get something to eat. Mm-hmm. Right?
Yeah, and to me a lot.
And usually it's going to be the first thing that we see, which is a Carl's Jr. for me.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
One thing that we can let everyone know is there was an MIT scientist who did some phenomenal research, Barry Sears.
Mm-hmm.
And he discovered that when you take the macronutrients, which are your carbohydrates, proteins, and essential fats, and you divide them up to a certain proportion to one another, it does impact your metabolism to burn fat. I did this with Shane Mosley, preparing him for Margarito's fight. His energy shot through the roof, and he was burning fat for energy.
Hmm.
Okay, it's called the zone diet.
What was he drinking?
Kangen water. And after his training, he got the Anespa. He said that Anespa shower was 100 times better than that jacuzzi. You know, but as far as your food is concerned, if you can break down, for every 7 grams of protein, you have around 9 grams of carbohydrates and 2.5 grams of essential fats like olive oil or peanut butter or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
It has been demonstrated by an MIT scientist that your metabolism will burn fat for energy.
You saying it'll increase instead of decrease?
Correct.
Wow. Now
I would like to, say this. When I was trying to find this picture of me when I had lost some weight. Because when I lost weight, it goes back to what Zoe said. What I was going to eat, I knew. I knew what I was going to eat.
Right.
Even when I was traveling out of town.
That's mm-hmm. what I was just about to say.
I landed and I went to the store, the grocery store. Mm-hmm. I made sure I had the refrigerator in my hotel room.
Right.
And it took discipline too.
Right. Yeah. Course, yeah.
That's
yeah.
the word. But once you lose, like, because when you're doing good, if you ever get off that routine, it's hard
getting back in that routine. Yeah, yeah.
So I want to say this to everybody out there who's feeling hopeless. Listen, if you can put the willpower together to put a routine like that together, in about a week or two, not only do you see a lot of results, it's not hard once you're on that routine.
Yeah.
It's just don't fall off.
Yeah.
Well, here's another thing you can do too, Corey. Build a team around you of people who
I was just about to say support.
You,
yeah. Support is huge.
People that really care about you, man, they gonna speak to that. They gonna say, look, man, I know you're struggling with this, man, stick with that, man, because you know, I want you to live the kind of life you're capable of living.
Right. Well, ask them to give you that support.
Right. Thank you. And if they don't, then you also have to be prepared. See, you're talking about all this structure for it, and that's great and everything. Beautiful. Majority of folks don't get that.
Right.
So you also have to look at the alternatives that you have. So when you're out there and you're running, and like you said, the first thing, I'm hungry, what do you see? So you got to map out and make either a conscious list of your alternatives while you're out there. That's all I do. So if I'm moving, I'm not going to say, oh, I can't get to my salads and I can't get to my market.
Really,
if I see something out there, I've got my alternatives at each one of those places. I know exactly what I'm going to get from these places and make my own better meal for myself at those places.
Really quickly, I think everybody that's listening to the show should get at Bobby. Bobby's going to give you an email address where you can get in contact with whoever. Because Bobby has been bringing the water to my crib. You know, he brings like 9-12 gallons of it, you know, a week. And my son drinks a lot of it. You know, he drinks it and you know, my son don't want to drink no other kind of water. You know, he got his own little gallon and he takes it to school with him every day. But I think the people who really want to get at Bobby about that water, because Bobby's about that water life. He about that moisture. So that's that tank top moist in a motherfucker because of that beating. But I'm telling you right now, y'all need to holler at him.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's the education, because this brother made it possible for me to change my mindset about water. I thought water was just water. And whether it's Kangen water or some other kind of water, believe it or not, because you don't look like it, you're 75% water. All right? And people are not hungry. They're thirsty. And if you get up in the morning, first thing, and you drink, I drink about a liter of water. And I don't even feel it, man, because, you know, for 6 hours or how long I've been asleep, because I get up early, don't know that, I get up 5 o'clock in the morning when I'm...
You don't feel it. Yeah. You lost your intestines years ago.
Yeah.
But this motherfucker's been embalmed.
I drink water first thing, man. And after you got to try something before you doubt it, all right?
Right?
And then I just look at other people that I've seen who have made those adaptations. Because it never dawned on me, because when I was younger, I used to drink sodas all the time, man. And I thought I had to clap, because my back was hurting. That's BD for y'all that ain't old enough.
I'm like, what the fuck?
You know? Because you can tell by your urine.
Well,
you're
from South Africa?
Your urine will tell you what's going on in your body. If That's your true. Urine is dark, you got some problem. If your stool ain't smooth, Nobody like talking about this, man. We got trouble shit, man.
We off the rails right now.
No, you're not. People know. They don't want to talk about it because they're going to end up dead.
Well, let me say this, and I guess we can ask Darlene to validate this. We talking about all of this health stuff. So let's, you know, this is the 5150 show. So I got to put this out there because I feel like this is something that enough people don't talk about as well. If you are a woman who is full of gyro meat, and mild sauce.
And what kind of sauce?
Mild sauce. That's like in Chicago, like bootleg barbecue sauce.
Gyro meat.
Right. God damn it. If you are a woman, with Italian sausage and Hawaiian bread in your system, does that affect the way your sweat and pussy and shit like that come out? Does that affect it?
Of course. A lot of what you eat affects your bacteria down there, so that's why you take probiotics.
Go ahead. No, you can go ask the same question I was going to ask. Go ahead.
Like if a girl eats a lot of green, healthy food, are you saying her pussy is supposed to smell better than a girl who eat a lot of McNuggets with the new seafood sauce?
Well, not necessarily just yes, Corey, I guess, but yes, but no, not just a lot of leafy greens, but a lot of probiotics, which is what they
eat. Does the woman's food contribute? The food she consumes contributes to the smell.
And her digestive system. I mean, you hear about all these women, and it is a woman's problem.
So do poor
majority
eaters,
of it is a woman's problem where they do not go to the bathroom enough. You hear these girls saying, you hear these girls saying that I've only gone twice. What? You're supposed to go at least 2 times a day. That speaks highly on their diet.
So if a bitch is pregnant and she eating Italian beef, when the baby suck her titty milk, is her titty milk affected by the dip juice that come off?
breast milk is affected by everything that's in your system. Boy. Everything.
She said if a baby is drinking the milk,
yes, no.
If a baby is drinking the milk of a stuffed pizza eating bitch.
Yeah.
His throat is affected by the milk.
Everything's affected by the milk. He's drinking it. He's ingesting it. Yes, Corey. Even eye drops. I had an eye infection in my eye and when I was 2-3 months old. So I had the eye drops were, what do they call it? Steroids. A form of steroids. Mm-hmm. So you taste it. So anything that goes in your system is going to go into your system so the baby would drink. So I had to stop.
So
but yeah,
I just want to know why Oprah...
Oprah
and all these people have never said, bitch, your system stank. That's why
they have
ain't no man with you.
In different,
stanky
different
system,
words,
bitch.
Corey.
We need to talk about this.
Different words, yes, they have. Yes,
stanky
they have.
System.
Right. I would imagine Oprah's system is full of a lot of waste. And big eyeball juice.
I think hers is good now.
What is big eyeball juice?
I don't know.
Either she had people playing with her booty.
You see how his diet's affecting him?
What? I'm asking. Tell me.
The way you're talking, I'm just playing, Corey.
Well, maybe your diet can affect the way you think. I don't know, but.
Yeah.
Yeah, it sure
if
does.
It can.
Yeah. Oh, big time.
Well, maybe that's what's wrong with me. My diet is, even when I was a kid.
Do you eat pork?
I don't eat pork or beef. I haven't eaten pork or beef.
What are you, a sumo wrestler, nigga? How you stay this big? What are you eating?
I'm full of carbohydrates.
This motherfucker's eating.
Well, then again,
car-sized loaves of bread, nigga.
You eat a lot of chicken, though.
I eat chicken.
You eat a lot of chicken, and nowadays, who knows what's in a lot of that chicken that you get in those restaurants? A lot of hormones, and steroids. That's why they want to know why the kids and everybody are bigger nowadays.
Exactly.
Just like when we was going home the other night, you're like, man. I wish that Thai restaurant was open. You know, it's already 11 o'clock, right?
Right, you don't eat that late, huh?
I try not to.
Try not to.
But Bobby, let me ask
you
a question.
I'm not comparing this. I'm just saying. But you smoke that late, don't you?
You know.
Bobby will wake up in the middle of the night and smoke, won't you?
This nigga Kagan water ain't clear.
His Kagan water is beige.
His Kagan water smell like the fire department put out a fire with that motherfucker.
Now, here's another trip, right?
It's pea smoky.
You could probably back this up on me. Now, if Bobby were to quit cold turkey, how much would he put on? Because people don't get that, too, that smoking curbs a lot of his appetite, too. and what he desires to eat. Because the moment that anybody stops smoking cigarettes, you just go look. Go do your research and see how much weight that they
blow
put
up
on.
A little bit.
Yeah.
I saw that, Bobby. I saw this guy. He books the comedy club down in Dallas. He gave up smoking, and he said, he was like, man, I started getting fat.
He started back smoking.
Yeah. He said, I'm going out like this.
So is nicotine a diuretic, is what you're telling me? No, it's just
putting the body through stress.
By him going cold turkey,
mm-hmm. it puts the body through stress. He may not feel it, but it is putting the body through stress because the body acclimates to whatever it is you condition it to. And if you suddenly change that cold turkey, you are going to put it through a tremendous amount of stress.
Even alcohol, people don't get that.
And in order to deal with that stress, which are just toxins that are building up in your body, in order for your body to keep you alive, it needs to create fat storages to put all your toxins in there.
Right.
Otherwise, you will die.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah, even alcohol. That's what happened to my mom and my sister.
So if you were to advise any of us, you know, like, let's just deal with Corey for a minute. What would be the first thing that you would address dealing with his desire to lose and keep weight off?
The first thing you have to do is balance the macronutrients because your body needs protein, carbs, and essential fats. You then have to supplement with the micronutrients, which are your vitamins, your minerals, all of that. You then have to start off exercising, which means you want to do casual walking every single day until your body recognizes all those feel-good hormones.
Mm-hmm. Dopamine. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Right. Serotonin, okay. Melatonin.
Once that happens, this is why a lot of runners, they will go and run regardless of whatever the conditions are because they will feel depressed to a certain small degree.
Because they need that. They need those endorphins.
The body says, hey, this was keeping me healthy. Now we're not running. What's going on?
Mm-hmm.
And like I was saying earlier, you know, we are a spiritual consciousness that incarnated into these bodies, and we were stuck with it. And these bodies can impact us, or we can impact the body. One of the two will occur, whether we choose to or not. So the idea is that, one, you have to prepare. You know when you get hungry during the day. Map out, as Zoe was saying earlier, map out what you're going to consume and when.
Right.
Okay? The human consciousness is the most powerful thing in this universe.
Go ahead. Did you make your point? Go ahead.
Yeah. And eat right, supplement correctly, because our foods do not contain the micronutrients that we need, and begin some form of casual walking exercise. Your body will say, hey, this walking is cool, but man, it would feel nice if we went for a little jog. Your body will indicate it to you.
Right.
So when we come back, the spiritual consciousness part of what the brother was saying, I mean, you know, I was on Zoe's show yesterday, and another brother was talking about the spiritual consciousness. Yeah. I want to get into that when we come back. Because that's something that isn't normally talked about. And I want to try to basically make sure everybody who doesn't catch all the big words has a pretty good definition of what spiritual consciousness means.
Let's do it.
So that's 5150 Show when we come back.
My dinner.
Listen, before we went to break, spiritual consciousness was brought up, and Zoe had a topic on his show yesterday where spiritual consciousness was brought up, because it is something that I think we need to recognize. So what I want to say is, if a obese woman get out of bed and the sheets are not straight, does that mean they're wrinkled, or are they frowning at her because her spiritual consciousness is obviously absentee in her body?
Now, why does it always have to be
shit
a heavy woman?
Deep.
Jesus Christ.
Because a heavy man can buy pussy. I'm talking frowning. Are they wrinkled, or are they frowning?
God damn.
Are sometimes you can frowning? Look at the sheets and you will see the faces the sheet is making. I know you didn't sleep on me all night, goddammit. That house coat smell like booty juice. Spiritual consciousness, how would you define it, Zoe? That's important. I want to know that.
I want to defer to the brother, because he's a wise one, he's a guest, and then I'm going to follow up with you. So, consciousness and spirituality and all of that.
Well, you know, different people define spirituality differently, and it's a different thing for different people. But when we're talking about consciousness, we're really referring to the self-aware I consciousness, right? This entity that incarnates into a human body. Mm-hmm. Okay. So in that regard, we can differentiate between that spiritual self-aware consciousness and, of course, the human body. Mm-hmm. And that's how I see what the spiritual consciousness is.
Right.
It's that entity that animates the human body that we're
I heard everything you said, brother, but Darlene just farted over
here. I did not. He heard
it. All that good I heard it.
All that good shit she eating.
Now, see, that's the body.
Believe Snuck me, if I did, you would know, because I own heard mine. Mine are, but yeah.
You know, before you take off, I think you just kind of hit on that spiritual part. I think we have a oneness with our body that we ignore a lot of time. Because sometimes you can feel something coming on, a mm-hmm. change, and you ignore it. And then you'll try to act like you didn't know, damn, man, I wasn't feeling good. It's a twin. It's like sometimes if you
get out of
line.
And that's majority men. I hate to say it, but that's majority prideful men. But go ahead.
Well, it can be a man thing. It is a man thing, because a lot of times we'll notice something is wrong and we won't deal with it.
We'll ignore it, yeah.
So the spirit is telling you as well as the body.
I be doing that shit all the time. I ignore a lot of shit.
You know.
Yeah. But I'm going to say I agree with everything the brother to my left said. 100% consciousness is awareness, you know. And a lot of times we are unaware of what's happening to us because we're not keeping track of what we're doing to ourselves.
Right.
And just conscious just means aware. That's all it does. That's mm-hmm. that's all it is. And I think, you know, going back to what we talked about earlier when we talked about planning out your life, not just what you do for a living, not just what you're reading, what you're taking in, but also what you're eating.
True.
You know, when you put it down and you regiment your life and you use the word discipline, when your life is disciplined in all of those factions, mm-hmm. this is what I tell my son. I tell my son, I say, boy, you are a manager. Yes. You're a life manager. You have to manage your emotions. You have to manage your diet. You have to manage your relationships. You have to manage your anger. And as you get more experience, you learn how better to manage yourself.
True.
And that's the whole key, and that's consciousness. You can't manage some shit you are unaware of.
And for the people out there who are looking for it, put in layman's terms, spiritual consciousness is that voice that talks to you when you cut off all the lights and you still eat pussy without looking at it.
Whenever wow. you do that,
shit just whenever you do that, something inside of you is going to talk. That's spiritual consciousness. That is the closest thing to God that can be defined. Your spiritual consciousness will tell you, you don't know this bitch like that, and you cut the light off, and you ate a pussy. So there's a pretty good chance when you cut the light on, you gonna look like that big lion that got the most of the antelope at the kill.
Well, with that, hey, I just thought of something. Would that get bigger men to get themselves in better shape if they knew that the sex would be easier and better?
Well, I heard some fitness lady say.
That's a great point.
She said something. I heard her say, some fitness lady say this on the Foxhole years ago. She said,
if a fat man lost,
like say he's 300 pounds mm-hmm. or 250, 270, whatever. She said if he lost 20 pounds, he would gain 2 inches a dick.
There it is, boom.
Now, is that true?
Sounds right to me.
Okay, you don't know. Shit.
No, he might have been with a big man that was big and lost some weight.
So but I'm saying the bigger you get, your dick shrink. Is that true? I don't know the science on that.
No, well, I want to ask Darlene a question, if I may.
What?
If a dude loses weight and...
Don't make no contest, no nasty contest.
No, I'm just asking you, what would your opinion of this be? If a guy loses weight, but his dick still don't work good with you, in particular as a woman, but he... dick work well with other women. Is it his weight or is it
you?
That bitch pussy holds no weight. That's what I'm asking.
First of all, most big men like that can't even do it correctly because their stomachs get in the way. I'm not lying. Yeah.
Well, what if he lift his stomach up and lay it on your back in doggy style?
I'm not even answer that. Good luck. Ain't happening. It's got to be reversed. You know that, right? For a bigger person.
So who has it worse?
So you're limited.
An obese woman in sex or an obese man in sex? Like, who has the worst?
The man. And gosh forbid the girl has a well-endowed backside. Good luck trying to get that.
How's he going to get it properly?
Yeah, how's it even going to reach?
But what do you mean? You saying if the guy's...
He's got his stomach in the way, she's got her butt in the way, I mean...
But see, with fat women, you're limited to positions. You can oil down folds.
And then, so whose satisfaction? The man's? What happens to the woman? Jesus Christ.
And fuck folds.
Well, who's satisfying that?
And still bust off.
The woman?
Well, what's in it for her?
Thank you.
You say, what's in it for her?
Yeah.
She don't get nothing. You just fuck a fold.
You can't, but see, as a man, you can't judge what another man is doing until you fuck one. I'm just saying. Until you fuck a man.
Oh, what? Oh, no, I didn't see. Wait, where'd that come from?
How can you judge what another man is doing with a woman until you fuck a man?
Where'd that come from?
I'm asking you.
I wouldn't know.
That's what I'm saying. That's the point I'm trying to make.
And I'll never know.
I done seen women stay with big motherfuckers even though they broke. So what? I'm just saying. Now, let me tell you something about a big girl. Now, a big girl, the only man with you are the broke ones.
No, wait a minute. Uh-huh. I have to
disagree. I heard big girl pussies hotter than others.
You heard?
Yeah. You ain't
never fucked a fat bitch.
I ain't fucked up an apartment building yet. But I was thinking, she got to be cute.
I want to hear what he had to say about the big girl.
When I worked for Diana Ross, she had a chauffeur. And this brother just loved big women. And he was the thinnest man I've ever seen in my life.
They usually are like that, yeah.
He wanted to get stuck somewhere.
No. That boy got hot. When he saw big women, it turned him off.
Mm-hmm. Well, like I said before, to me, the most beautiful big woman I've ever seen is Jill Scott. Mm. I would love to be with that.
I don't think she's that big, though. See, that's the thing.
Jerome Bettis.
She's curvy, thank you. She's curvaceous. Got a nice...
Don't make excuses for beautiful. Jill Scott.
Hey, Jill Scott is beautiful.
She's not big, but you said
Jill
big.
Scott got an NFL throat.
What?
Let's
hell?
Stop acting like this bitch is bad.
What is an NFL throat?
Look at NFL players.
Oh my God.
Jill Scott got an NFL throat, and if we ever got in an argument, the first thing I would say, shut your purse throat ass up, bitch. That bitch's throat looked like a new coach purse.
Mm. Come on, man. That what? Is just a beautiful you like woman.
Mm. She is very beautiful. Yeah.
I didn't say she wasn't beautiful. I said her throat.
You saying it's big? What is that? How did her throat get big? What happened?
Her throat got Gucci bag shit working with it.
Anyway.
She got Gucci bag throat.
Anyway, we need to take you guys to Club Bounce. Remember I told you about that club I went to, Corey? Oh, it specializes in all
I don't understand.
Skinny guys.
Darlene says she knows about a club out here in California.
Yeah, it's called Club Bounce. And I went and they ignored. For fat bitches.
I bet you that motherfucker is hot and smelly.
It is. So interesting because
they sell more Bloody Marys than any other club. The bitches, give me you ain't got no soup. Well, fuck, give me the Bloody Mary.
And like you said,
chop
all
some
them,
chicken
all
wings
the
up in that motherfucker.
Skinny.
It works it's like a potluck. You don't pay money to get in. You bring food.
It's a fetish.
All right, so tell me, do you disagree about this, Bobby? I don't give a fuck who the guy is, skinny or whatever. When guys go for obese bitches, they just don't want to work hard. Do you disagree with that?
I do, because I done seen scenes that had women that was just perfect shapes, and then they've had women that had other attractions for them, you know.
What? Like what?
It's just something, man. You drawing the picture.
Yeah, you got
man.
Caught up. Look, let me tell you something. You go for that big hole. That means you don't want to work hard. Man, them big hole.
Man, I know, like the brother said, man.
You women, saying big girls are easier?
Man, I know women that are big girls, man, that's got plenty action.
Fat bitches fuck faster.
Plenty action.
Than bitches who got a shape.
We need to hear from the chat room on that. Do you agree or disagree? Everybody, it's easier to get fat pussy than it is to get skinny, thick, bad pussy.
I'm not saying
somebody keeping a man. Keeping a man is something different. What I'm saying is, if you decide to come to L.A. and try to make it as an entertainer, you need to go look for fat bitches at the grocery store because they will let you move in that day. Fat hoes are lonely and they bed and their sheets are upset.
There are some fat bad bitches out here who don't think that way.
Look, let me tell you
something. Can we pull up a fat bad bitch on the internet? Does anybody have a picture of a fat beautiful bitch that's like, nigga, I'm choosing?
No, it's not. But let
me say
this.
Yes, no, because they're going to try and go get more money because that's the only way they can get their girls.
But I'm going to respond to that. Let me tell you something. I have seen some very attractive fat bitches. I saw that picture, so I was looking for it. I've seen some very attractive fat bitches. But, and they always say, but I'm pretty, though. And I always tell them, it don't matter if you're pretty. God damn it, your car seat whoa out, bitch. All them fat hoes walk to their car. Especially if they didn't have that car about 2 years. That seat looked like a wallet.
Oh, that's cool.
The gangbangers stomped out. Fat hoes, we need to face it. Dolly trying to be
so
nice.
You said because they fat. They're naturally
the
destructive.
The world is bad on fat bitch, especially if you upper body fat. Lower body fat, I'm just saying, I think they got it better. But when you got that that shit, that superhero shit up here.
That Mr. Incredible right. build.
If all your selfies are right here, you don't show your neck. Bitch, it's a cold world for you. Right there.
Whether she cute in the face or not.
It don't matter if you cute in the face. All the bitches who motherfucking profile pics on Twitter, well, that shit be right there. I know that's that wallet throat bitch. I mean, the Gucci bag throat
Corey,
bitch.
But anyway, at the end of the day, people like now what they like. People like what they like.
I'm not that's talking. It. If somebody want to call me fat, I'm with that. But let me say this. If you a man and you got weight on you, you don't have the same obstacles as a woman who got weight on her ass.
In America, that is the rule.
What country where it ain't the rule?
So you telling me, I need to be clear, you're telling me fat women are less attractive than fat men?
A ugly bitch in shape will get a man quicker than a cute fat bitch.
Wow.
See, he disagrees.
Some people can. I get people will disagree. Of course, people will disagree.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
But I'm just telling you what I've seen.
Or what you like to each
other. Not what I like. I'm telling you what I've seen.
Industry of porn, BBWs, SBBW, supersized, big, beautiful women.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, it's a whole industry of motherfuckers who love these big, giant, Fatosaurus Rexes. They love them.
BBW DVDs are on the clearance rack immediately.
Jesus.
God damn it. You know when you watch BBW DVDs, when you just sat through about 4 hours of porn, you be like, fuck, let me see what this fat bitch doing.
Let's see how she gobble.
You don't go buy the big bitch DVD. You stumble across it.
You stumble across it.
You be like, fuck it, I got this one. You be like, fuck it, let me see my auntie. This look like my auntie at the cookout. I want to see that shit. That ain't nothing against a fat bitch. I'll smash a fat bitch, but I'm just saying, if we ever get in an argument, I'm going to remind her, bitch, I really didn't want to fuck you anyway.
Oh, that's just
and y'all make romantic. Me laugh. Y'all say, you telling me an ugly bitch that's thick will get chose. I mean, a fat bitch who cute will get chose before an ugly bitch that's thick.
You mean an ugly bitch with a better body? Is that what you're saying?
I think it would depend on the man.
That's morning face, though. It's
so
that
saying,
morning
it's to
face.
Each his own.
Like,
ooh. Yeah.
Everybody say that shit. It depends on the man.
It was late.
People have a certain like just what they're attracted to.
Right.
Morning face man shuts it down.
I think men have it a lot easier, especially with a woman who just is real. Because I'm not unattracted to a big man.
You've been with a big man before?
Oh yes. Rodney
okay.
Jerkins.
What did you like about the bigness?
He was about 500 when I dated him, huh?
What did you like about
him? Did you say somebody was 500 pounds?
Yes.
Who?
Rodney Jerkins. He was 500.
Who was Rodney Jerkins? Google this motherfucker.
Yeah.
You dated Rodney Jerkins.
Yes.
And he was 500 pounds when you dated
him. I would say he's about 500
I guess that
pounds.
Was the height of his
was
career.
He a big
this
time
nigga
music,
no,
was he a big-time music producer? Of course his fat didn't bother.
Oh, stop. No, he was just the biggest
produced
one.
Michael Jackson, produced Brandy, a lot of motherfuckers.
I said the biggest. Not. I've dated all, my friend Ron. He's a big fella. But then he
Rodney
just
Jerkins
ended up going to the hospital
pounds?
And then he had to lose weight. Because he got sick.
I didn't know that motherfucker was 500 pounds.
It was about, I'm going to show you photos. Yeah.
I want to see a 500-pound man that can fuck.
You ain't going to be the missing.
I didn't say that. Who said that?
How does all these motherfuckers get to date you, but you don't fuck? I just
hold on, Zoe. I want to see her fix this. So you didn't fuck
her? I'm not gonna answer that, but I'm saying you. Throw that means yes. You already know I don't talk about that.
Well, we just gonna
say. Well, if you didn't fuck him, that ain't no date.
I'm not gonna say it. You just said you wanted to know how
you ate free off him at a restaurant.
But you're not gonna hear about that part.
You ate free off of him at a restaurant.
I said I didn't say I didn't. I'm just not gonna elaborate on it. Is all I'm saying.
God damn.
You didn't
say
you didn't. You're not gonna elaborate. Right, you don't have to tell what happened when he walked to the bathroom. But I'm just saying when you come.
They post a
that he skeeted in the room with you.
Twitter is posting some bad, thick, curvy ones, boy.
What do you mean?
Twitter, they posted some bad.
I will say this about me: I don't like big titties. Yeah. I like regular sized titties.
Sometimes big titties stink.
Too much.
Big titties stink a lot. Don't say sometimes.
There's
a lot of bitches with gyro meat under their chest plate.
Why is it always gotta be big men too? If that's the case, but I'm just saying big.
Smegma under their nipples.
They don't take care of themselves. Anybody bigger?
When men get to the point where they got titties, they fit this category. But I'm talking about women with big.
Did you see
titties.
How good Rick Ross
you don't like that
was? Oh my God! By the way,
what's that?
You don't like that there, boy?
I can't see her, but she got real big titties.
You don't
look,
like that deal?
I'm not saying I won't indulge
that's good
in big
right
titties.
What I am saying,
he doesn't prefer.
I come to bed with them motherfucking handy wipes when I fuck bitches with big titties, and I lift them up.
No, he's right. You know,
and
Corey's
I rub
right
the motherfucker.
Right.
They don't get no such thing as titty deodorant. Right. They need something.
Titty deodorant is a genius idea.
They need titty deodorant.
They have
chafing
stuff like that for big
people. If they're going to make love to you, have sex, they're going to fuck, whatever they need to go. They should shower before doing so, right?
No, what I'm saying is a girl can shower, but if she walks around outside with big titties, it doesn't take long. For that motherfucker to smell like gangbanger socks.
Just like a chubby man with their neck and their breasts. Chubby men have breasts too now. Yeah. So they have they have breasts and they have all that neck going on.
Very true.
So the sex between two fat motherfuckers got to just...
The worst smell
that's some dumpster shit right there. Dumpster love.
That is some nasty stuff right there.
Yeah. Well, most guys have smelly sacks because actually to clean your sack, it takes about 5 minutes. Most guys just wipe that motherfucker with the soap.
And they go the wrong way.
And they don't realize.
And they got all that skeet marks.
That sack juice, when you put that soap on it, it'd be like, that ain't shit.
Nigga.
I ain't going up. This motherfucker gonna wipe me. I'm here. The fuck you thought?
Nigga, I'm made from the trichinosis worm, nigga. I ain't going nowhere.
God damn it. I've been living here for 4 months. Nigga, they ain't got rid of me. This motherfucker been wiping me for months. I'm ill here.
Look like a turkey neck.
So fat people really need to soak.
Not even fat people. Sack cleaning is a process. And they don't have college courses for this. When I really care about a girl, I take the extra 5 minutes. To clean my sack.
So romantic.
You can't clean your sack
so
with
romantic.
Just regular soap. You need a rag to clean your sack.
Industrial soap, right?
Exfoliate them.
You need a rag to clean your sack.
And some Comet.
You can't use that. You can't use that hotel soap to clean your sack. That little chip. You tell the girl you with, look, bitch, ain't nothing different with these chips. So if you fuck with this sack, that's on you. To clean your sack, you need that real soap. That rag. That rag got to be yeast infection soap. That motherfucker, you got to be able to touch it in the soap. Be like, yeah. And you got to wipe that motherfucker 4 times and rinse.
Oh, my God.
It's a process to have a clean sack. So you can feel good. When a girl suck your sack and you know it stink, God damn it, that bitch deserves an outfit.
What was the name of that soap that mechanics used to use? Lava. That old gristly soap. It's a pump. They niggas need that shit.
For the sack.
But
basically what we just came down to is that anybody on the bigger side needs to take up some more time to
make lava. This is an internet show, so we could actually show somebody in here washing up, like a girl washing under her titties the proper way. And I ain't gonna lie. For all the ladies and the Zoe fans, we could have a dude cleaning his sack.
Fuck you,
what? I don't think
Zoe fans. Oh, you
had to get me back because of the little water balloon slide. Yeah. I got you. I see. Okay.
All right. I'm fucking with you.
Yeah.
No, but look, I think that'll be something that's never been done. A proper wash up.
This motherfucker. Thick maybe ass we can fitness do guru over here.
No, I'm telling you, listen. Tell me, do you disagree? There's a lot of people out here who don't know how to properly wash up, especially with guys. They don't clean their feet.
That's true.
Yeah. Guys don't actually clean. Wash their feet, and they've never been taught that.
And they don't wipe their backsides right. Very well either.
Yeah, so yeah. Maybe we can have a wash-up show. I'm serious, man.
A wash-up tutorial.
Well, you got to think of something different,
yeah,
man.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. A wash-up show, how to wash your ass for people you care about who do freaky shit.
That's what Red Fox used to say. He said, you need to wash your ass. He said, I ain't talking about your whole ass. I'm talking about your asshole.
Look, yeah. So that's what I want to ask Red you, Bobby. Fox. Do you think it's gay for a man to get all the shit out his ass in the shower?
He needs to do that you need to do that, man.
So you saying you done poked your finger in your ass?
No,
that's what I'm asking.
Nah, I didn't do
Bobby,
that.
Bobby, it's okay. You got to clean your ass, man.
I ain't stuck my finger in my ass.
So your ass ain't never been clean is what you're telling the American public right now.
No, I done washed the hell out of my ass, but I ain't washed my ass.
I done washed the hell out of my ass, but I ain't never poked myself.
All the ladies out there know Bobby ass is clean on the outside. But once he start walking, all that shit in that little holding tank, that's what I call it. The little holding tank lining. That shit is dropping. Bobby played basketball today. I know his shit on his drawers right now. But he just admitted he didn't wipe his ass.
God damn.
I mean, you know, you said you wiped your ass. You ain't never plucked in your ass to get the shit out your ass.
No.
Bobby gonna have colon cancer.
Get the fuck out of here.
Bobby got shit from the 4th of July in his ass right now.
It ain't that kind of part.
What the fuck is going on?
No, what? See, y'all sitting here talking about health. Let me tell you something. Bobby has an unhealthy ass. He ain't never pulled the shit out that little. It's a
yeah, area.
What do you call that area? The little sleeve. You got a little sleeve. It's about
the part that stretches when you go back.
The shit from in the inside to come out the hole is a little sleeve. Whatever it's called, sphincter, motherfucker, no, whatever. What is it? Is that what it's called? A sphincter?
I don't know.
It's a sleeve, a little hole, a little twizzler.
Bobby got a dirty twizzler.
Corey's twizzler.
Bobby got one of the black twizzlers.
You got a licorice twizzler.
You got that twizzler, don't nobody buy.
Corey's twizzler is called.
Oh, fuck, man. Stop.
Damn. I can't.
So, does that make me homosexual? Because
real men got streaks. What the fuck?
Who said that?
Let me ask you this, America and the fact, does it make me gay that I have cleaned my ass twizzler before?
Your own self, girl.
So I can violate me, just long as no other man do it.
Okay, why not?
Because when I be cleaning my twizzler, I'll be like, this is some gay shit. I'm in here.
No, stop. No, you're just.
I done found some more shit beyond the Twizzler. Like in the inside there. And I done cuffed it and brought it out. No, but it was a girl. But it was a girl I care about. I cared about the girl. And I'm just saying.
The question is, nigga, do you like it while you're doing it, Corey?
It's very uncomfortable. I have to keep toilet paper in my shower. I'm the only man with toilet paper in the shower. So when I find them little chunks that didn't come out in the outburst.
In the eruption.
Because there's little chunks in there sometimes.
That's why you need to go get your colon cleanse. Remember colon cleanse.
I think I cleaned my own colon.
You don't need a flush, you don't need a colon cleanse.
I don't know. I'm saying.
It sounds to me like he needs a colon cleansing.
So you ain't never been up in your Twizzler?
You don't have to go up in the anus. I mean,
how do you clean your ass?
You clean the
outside.
With a soapy dildo.
It's sort of inside, but it ain't
all you guys who've been dreaming of Darlene. She got a dookie booty.
No, Corey, because I go quite frequently. I go quite frequently. It cleans itself.
If you don't get up at the Twizzler, it ain't clean. Then you get in the Twizzler.
If I knew what the Twizzler was, you may have to show us.
Ain't that like a woman to play dumb?
You may have to show us, Corey.
Oh, my God.
Healthy brother.
Here we go.
I know you tough and you done checked the shit out of motherfuckers. But is that
I'll beat your ass.
Is that ass Twizzler on point right now? That's
what I'm saying.
Yeah, see? That's a hell of a question, Ash. Is your ass Twizzler on point, nigga?
I'm going to get Corey some suppositories so you don't have to put your
what
finger
is a suppository?
There.
We got to be accountable for each other. Is your ass Twizzler on point? Oh,
wait, what?
Shit.
That's suppository. I said I need to get Corey some suppositories.
She said it's a thing made out of gel.
It's a gel. It looks like a little bullet.
Liquefy the loose chunks.
Right. You put it up in there and with your finger, and then it cleanses everything out. Goes in.
In your
mouth. He knows what a suppository is, yeah.
Jamie Foxx, we want you to watch this show. Twizzler cleaning.
Twizzler cleaning 101.
Twizzler cleaning with fingers. We don't know about that shit you be on, homie.
Oh, my God.
Man, first of all, I joke with Jamie. I like Jamie Foxx. Yeah, God damn it, he is a fucking star.
Yes, he is.
God damn it.
Anyway, well, we learned one thing today, that's for sure, is that Corey has the cleanest ass hole in
when
town.
I care about you, I don't clean my ass all the time. That's so, another process. To clean your sack right and get your ass Twizzler clean, that's about 10 minutes in the shower.
Jesus,
your feet soggy at the bottom.
You can't take a 10-minute shower in California.
Your feet are soggy at the bottom.
Yeah, you know, your feet get soggy.
We should get Don Lemon in here to give a Twizzler cleaning tutorial.
Don Lemon got lip gloss on his Twizzler.
Oh, my God.
That nigga got lip gloss on his asshole. Hey, man, what we
had
on time?
The game.
So look,
God damn.
Listen, we had a lot of crazy shit we said on this show.
For real.
But I think people, even though we said a lot of crazy shit, I know it's on people's mind the shit we talked about as far as it go. We're getting
yourself
on track.
Yeah, right. Take care of yourself.
I don't care how obese you are. Don't give up, man.
Please.
Don't give up. If you wake up in the morning, God damn it, that is all you need to do to start your life right as far as it go with eating. Just having the ability to get up and walk to the motherfucking car.
Right. Right.
You know what I mean? If you
pick
can still
up.
Do that,
yeah. You good.
Yeah.
Pick it up.
So yep. On the right. Real, man, we want you to get
your. So you in Cleveland down. This week?
I'm this week I'm going down to Cleveland to work at the Improv. We got shows that are basically damn near sold out now, so I know they're going to add shows. Cleveland, y'all be looking out. I love y'all motherfuckers in that little pussy-ass town with that stanky-ass river. LeBron back. I'm coming with a whole lot of hair dye. and Sharpies to make linings on. Case I meet LeBron. No, I'm just fucking with you. Hey, LeBron, good looking out. Goofy shit. But I want to get everybody here a chance to plug their shit. Darlene, she has her book.
I have my book coming out in Valentine's 2015, but like I said, also, I still instruct my classes, which Corey did try, so I'm waiting on Bobby and Zoe.
Right.
Okay, so I'm down to one gym now. I used to be at two, but I needed the time to write the book, so now I'm still at Hollywood Y, so if you ever want to come by. And then they have good pickup games there, too, so if you ever want to go in as a guest on Saturdays, there's good pickup games there too as well.
Okay,
so
cool.
Come through. Cool. But follow me on Twitter at DarleneOG_Ortiz and the same on Instagram.
There you go.
All right. If you want some more information about why health matters, get at me at Bobby@realmendontplay.com and get my book, please. Some people getting into pick up the news, and I hope others will do likewise. You can also get at me at Glanton Smith on Twitter.
Okay, so all jokes aside, website iamzoewilliams.com. We're launching a lot of things for 2015. I too have my second book coming out Valentine's Day 2015 as well, The Relationship Dismount. We have my life coaching. Anybody who wants life coaching, serious life coaching, like, you know, no bullshit, go to the website, fill out the questionnaire. My books, t-shirts, everything can be found at I Am Zoe Williams. Follow me on Twitter at Zoe Williams. Join our YouTube page, The Zoe What Show on YouTube, and on Instagram at Mr. Zoe What.
All right.
There you go.
Brother got anything to plug? He just on chill mode.
Yeah. He can't. He's crying.
I want to tell you, man, we appreciate you coming, man.
Ed Martin, ladies and gentlemen.
Ed Martin. Thank you. Zoe got some bullshit to plug.
Stay tuned for the game.
Uh-oh.
After the show.
Definitely. Ooh, please, I was about to let everybody know. Listen, now I want everybody to know it's just a basketball game, but I feel like it will be entertaining for everybody who saw what happened last week between these motherfuckers talking shit, and just everybody who know the 5150 family, because we went out there, we acted fool.
Yeah.
So,
just for y'all. Uh-huh. You pussy-ass motherfuckers.
Thank goodness nobody got hurt. Y'all play good.
Love and hate you niggas simultaneously.
Somebody say I'm about to go to the shower and get my Twizzler yanked.
Let's see if they got a couple of good jokes. Let's see. Throw your best shit out. We'll read it right now on the way out of this bitch.
Wait a minute. No,
drop the episode with Brandy.
Right.
Oh, no.
That ain't funny right there. I am Zoe the Crease. What the fuck is that? Anyway.
Zoe book called... My invisible hairline. That's good.
Zoe got hair though.
Oh, what's the guest name?
Let's see.
Ed Martin.
Zomosexual.
Did Zoe play ball in that hat?
Yeah.
Why did you play in that hat? I just realized that.
I got a big deformed LL Cool J head.
Man, look, man. Show your head.
Listen,
man.
Join my Instagram page. I got a picture of me without a hat on holding my son. Bald
I just realized Zoe be having on a hat a lot.
All the time.
Yeah.
Are you too shy to take your hat off?
I'm not too shy.
Well, take the motherfucking hat off.
I will not.
Zoe got the tetties.
He's got a tatter.
What is it? Old school shit.
Say it again.
Tetties.
Somebody said Zoe got two brains. Exactly. Smart enough not to fuck with you
niggas.
I just
realized Zoe played that game in that hat. Anyway. Hey, y'all, that's what's up. Thanks for looking out. We'll see y'all. Watch this puss-ass game. And we'll get at y'all next week, man. 5150, we out.
Go.
Ooh, Bobby got
the white beater. Tank top. Corey, who you got?
Hey, Bobby.
If the tank top lives, fool.
Let's do this shit. Hey, adorn the trophy.
Yeah, let's do this. I want to see this. This is going to be...
All right,
spectacle.
Shoot for the ball, man. We shooting? You shooting for the
Murfreesboro,
ball.
Tennessee.
Versus Chattanooga.
One of your favorite sons. Chattanooga. Not too far from each other. We're about to see these boys.
We're going in the alley.
Go at it in this real.
Going in the alley.
This real test of manhood out here. It's going down. Bobby, they don't know who to go. No, this is how we gonna do it. This is how we gonna do it. Let me see it. Let me see it. No, we jumping this off ghetto style. Y'all jumping for it.
Get your ass over here.
What you mean? You get on one side, he get on the other.
Tell him to get on this side.
Oh, y'all arguing about sound. Come on, let's do it right here where it don't matter. This ain't a traditional basketball game. I know this ain't how the shit supposed to start. You on one side of the line, Bobby, on the other side of the line.
Bobby, I'm already open.
I'm your elbow. Go sideways. Corey, go right sideways. Go sideways. So they're both on that line.
Let's go.
Throw the ball right here.
Right.
Let's go.
All right, we're about to jump off.
Yeah. Ain't nobody ever jumped out, motherfucker.
I know this is goofy as hell, but this is like this is 5150 ball. No, we ain't shooting for it, Bobby. Get on over here with your swimsuit on. All right. Bam.
Got him! There you go, Bobby!
It's all 5150. Look, oh, Bobby! What? Look at Bobby! Representing the Dr. J era. Woo! Oh, wow! Bobby's down! Zoe, lay it up! But Bobby recovered! Bobby got up! Zoe is up! This game go to 7. Game go to 7.
Let's go!
Zoe's up 1-0. He's quick. Look at Bobby. Do not sleep on Bobby. Bobby is ready. There it is, Zoe. Uh-oh, Zoe. Uh-oh, Bobby got the ball. Representing all of the men with Curtis Blow albums in the garage. Bobby is, uh-oh, he's back. Zoe ain't playing. Look at them eyes.
You can't
play.
Everybody who wanted Michael Sam to make the team is rooting for Zoe. Bobby, you're using too much energy. I hope Bobby can withstand. He's trying to back down game. It's the old school game, Adrian Dantley style, but it's going to take a lot of energy from Bobby. But Bobby drinks that great water that he charges people for, that he brings in dirty containers and tells you to drink that bullshit. So we'll see if the Kagan water works for Bobby. So that's a sign of tired shit right there. Whenever you're on your knees, that means you're fucking tired. That means he do too many of these. With them hoes. We need to do more workout shit. You gotta work out more.
I fucked this morning.
This is good exercise right here. But this is good exercise. But you gotta do more workout shit. All right, Bobby went to go get the ball. That took all the 20 minutes, didn't it? So wiping the ball off.
It's got dirt on it.
Dirt is part of the game. Let's get dirty. So, Bobby, Bobby is moving.
Oh, man, goddamn.
Oh, they calling these frivolous fouls.
You got his hand on my back, man.
He ain't gonna give you nothing easy, Bobby, but y'all don't.
No, he can't hold me. Fight.
You see, Zoe got on them.
Yeah.
Zoe got on them.
He can't hold me.
Uh-oh, Bobby kept the rebound. Bobby, let it go again. Bobby got it. Uh-oh, Zoe's shoes are sponsored by X Mark the Spot. Uh-oh, Zoe pulled up. Don't pull it up with confidence. Bobby's back out there. The tank top! Oh, it almost went in.
Look, Zoe's looking confident. It's that light skin shot.
Oh! Look, Bobo! I'm gonna get the ball. That's it.
Let's get it cracking. Zoe's up 2-0. Game to 7. It's starting to look bad for Bobby. Bobby tank top is getting browner. Oh! Bobby gets the shot back. Come on. Bobby's Hanes tank top look real loose at the bottom. He got a hole in it. He got shot and survived. Oh, Bobby! Did you see Bobby?
Bobby
got that shot. Bobby pulls up. He's like, I ain't no fool. Uh-oh, Zoe. Come on. Your voice of reason defensively. Oh, Bobby. It looks like he's confident in that shot. It's just not going down. Zoe pulls up. Oh my God, Bobby. Bobby has tied. Bobby has tied the game, ladies and gentlemen. The game is tied. 2-2. Bobby, look at him. Ready. Shoots with confidence. Oh.
That's Zoe ball. Ball went out of bounds. Ball goes to Zoe. You guys check up. Be gentlemen now. Don't start hating each other.
Record it, record it, record it.
All right.
Bobby has on the starter gym shoe. Zoe pulls up. Zoe's starting to look unconfident. Bobby.
Oh!
Bobby is up! Ladies and gentlemen, we never thought Bobby would be up in this game, but he's up 3-2.
He's up. Go ahead, Bobby!
Go, Bobby!
Bobby representing the Bingo Long All-Stars. Oh! He almost made that! Look at that! Oh my God! Look at Bobby!
I will never take Bobby for granted again. Zoe just went out of bounds.
Uh-oh, Zoe. West Coast ball. Uh-oh. Zoe. Bobby gave him a foul. That's good sportsmanship. Come on, guys.
I know you're tired, all right? The whole 5150 nation is watching this 101. That
the score is 3-2. Tank top winning. Zoe pulls up.
Damn.
Oh, that is a beautiful shot that just won't drop. Look at Bobby. Look at, oh my God, Bobby. Bobby smokes most cigarettes than goddamn it, a bitch who about to get out of jail in 2 weeks. But he got energy. Bobby got energy. Zoe's pulling up. Zoe is confident. Oh, the game is tied at 3-3. Zoe hit that long jumper. 3-3. Come on. Which one of these Titans are gonna win? Oh, Zoe, that was a good shot. That rim is actually tight. Uh-oh. When the rim is tight, it's harder for the shots to fall. But they're shooting the ball. All right. Zoe, shoot. Oh, Zoe is up 4-3. Bobby got phased. Come on, Bobby.
Short.
Bobby has the rebound. All the bitches with straightening combs at home are counting on Bobby.
Bobby is a hustler. Bobby plays physical. You can tell he's a lot more physical than he is now. Uh-oh, I'm watching this. Ball goes out, Bobby ball.
Maybe we should have made the game to five.
That's what I said. I said five.
But we can't change it now. Because the score is 4-3. 4-3 right now. 4-3. Check it out. So, voice of reason. Shoot from the top.
Damn it.
That fatigue is starting to set in. Those shots are being a little shorter. Fatigue is starting to shed in.
Bobby. Oh, the score is tied. The score is tied, 5-5. These two titans of the gridiron. That's football, ain't it?
Yeah, my man.
Oh, Bobby. Bobby, he's breathing. His mouth is open. Bobby doesn't look as tired as I thought he would be.
Bobby looks like he's in shape.
Bobby is in great shape. He looks like the ball is, Bobby is taking his time.
The card is slippery. I should have told you, sorry.
That's funny, bro.
Bobby wanted that rest anyway.
Oh,
Zoe needs the rest.
I need it.
Bobby needs the rest.
I gotta give Bobby some props.
You guys need a timeout?
Really good for his age.
Give him a 2-minute timeout. 2-minute timeout.
Uh-oh.
For a commercial break.
Pause that.
All right, we got a commercial break.
And we got
we're gonna do that. No more commercial.
No. We got Best Corey's back.
No more. I just beat the bitch because she was talking shit. No more her eye swole because she fell. Nah, I leave that shit alone.
You was on somewhere, but you didn't know what the next step was.
This is a black basketball game, so we got to do some black commercial. Try Popeye chicken, Cajun style. We got it over here for you. Come on over here and dine your fatties.
Bobby is drinking his famous Cajun water that he got from the world famous Adonijah.
The world famous faucet filter.
Somebody hit the faucet filter. It's in his head, it's working. But Bobby is, real talk, Bobby has got a lot more energy than I thought he would. I was worried about Bobby fatiguing, but
oh, hell no.
Is that a word, fatiguing?
I thought Bobby would be done after like 2 points.
Here we go.
Ooh, Bobby got
the white beater
tanked up. Corey, who you got?
Hey, Bobby.
The tank top lives, fool.
Let's do this shit.
Hey, adorn the trophy.
Yeah, let's do this.
I want to see this. This is going to be a spectacle.
Shoot for the ball, man.
We shooting?
You shooting for the
Murfreesboro, Tennessee.
Versus Chattanooga.
One of your favorite sons. Chattanooga. Not too far from each other. We're about to see these boys.
We're going in the alley.
Go at it in this real.
Going in the alley.
This real test of manhood out here. It's going down. Back in it. 4-peak. Uh-oh. Shot with some defense on you. Let's see if Bobby. Oh, look at Bobby. He's running in those starter shoes. And he stopped.
The Skechers.
Right. Bobby is sponsored by Skechers.
Oh,
that was a good bank.
I feel like Bobby goes for these banks too. I feel like he don't just shoot
where
he's
that's going. That's the old school ball. That's the old school ball. Uh-oh. Zoe got his own rebound. Zoe is ready to give it to Bobby right here with that shot. I could tell. I knew it. He faced up. Score is 5-4. Come on, guys. No heart attacks out here. 5-4. I tell you what, no matter what happens, Bobby has my respect. Bobby has my respect. I thought Zoe was going to run away with this fucking thing. Zoe, you still got my respect, but even though I'm just saying that because we cool. The score is 5-4. Can Bobby pull it out? Can he be the dark horse? Can he be the dark horse? Nobody expected Bobby to win. Cajun water is dripping from his forehead. Oh, the game! Bobby is not going away! Bobby is not going away! 51-50 exclusive. A 51-50 exclusive. Zoe's taking his time. The score is 5-5. The loser has to bump chest with a nigga in a pink outfit on Santa Monica.
No.
Oh!
Zoe hit the jumper.
Bobby, you're going to have to exert a lot of energy.
Game point. Game point.
25.
Zoe needs 1 point. Bobby needs 2 points. The 5150 show will be a musty room today, ladies and gentlemen. It's going down. So, for the marbles. Oh, he misses. Sometimes when you go up and you only have one. Bobby shot the bank. Come on, Bobby, this is everything. Do you know how many people are gonna watch this game? Do you know how many people online are gonna watch this game? Zoe, I wanna see you shoot that fadeaway. Oh, Zoe, that was not a fadeaway, I don't think. That was something else. Bobby almost tied the game. Does Bobby have the willpower to stop Zoe defensively? Can he stop him? Zoe to the hole.
I ain't gonna call it.
Oh, he didn't call it. Zoe played. That was good sportsmanship. Bobby.
Come on, Bobby.
I can see.
Game point, both.
Bobby is starting to lose will. And Zoe Williams backs up the talk at the table, and he beats Bobby.
Get him all good. You got to get him the lights.
Can we talk to Zoe?
I respect my uncle.
Can we talk to Zoe?
Zoe. I respect my uncle.
You lost, Bobby. We interview you last. Zoe, as you were playing Bobby, did you know you were going to win?
Absolutely. Unequivocally.
Can you give Bobby some respect because he plays you pretty close?
I knew he was going to be tough. I talked a lot of shit, but I know Bobby is a fit-ass old man. And I knew he was going to come because that's just who he is.
Would you ever run a train with an Uber bitch with Bobby?
No. He got baby flake powders.
Baby flake powders.
Baby powder flakes on his balls. He'll fuck the pussy up. He'll
I want you to know you played a good game, Zoe, and we appreciate this. Bobby, come here. The tank top is a little wet. Let me tell you something.
You gotta wear the tank top tonight.
I got mad respect for you. I didn't know you had that much energy. Bobby, how old are you?
60.
Let me tell you something. I don't know 60-year-olds who can do like what that. Bobby just did
exactly.
there. So as we talk shit about Bobby, on that motherfucking air, you know Bobby gonna outlive a lot of you motherfuckers.
No question.
Bobby lives healthy and he only smokes square. So let me ask you something, Bobby. If I bought you some victory pussy, would you be able to do it? Would you
right now?
Right now? Okay, we're gonna get a hooker out here somewhere on Van Nuys Boulevard, and we're gonna get Bobby a chance to skeet on somebody he don't know.
Right now.
5150 show.
Hey, I like to
beat him by two.
I like for y'all to understand, I appreciate this brother getting that fire in them green eyes and coming on with it and proving that he had to bring it like that. And maybe in 6 months, I'm gonna embarrass this nigga.
Now, let me tell you something. I ain't played no ball. Show y'all something. Get this on camera.
No! Go ahead, Corey. Show him you sick.
I'm about to make a fool out of myself.
I hope not.
No, he can still dump.
When you naturally got it.
He can still dump. I got, no, I'm gonna get 2 weeks. Not 6 months. I got you in 2 weeks. Nah, bro, that's why I'm gonna get this nutrition show going tonight. We get in where he's supposed to be.
I wouldn't have missed all them shots, though, even though I ain't got them ups no more.
Okay.
I'll let you have it, goddamn.
He's next. That's next. Then it's the winner gets you.
That's how we do it.
Win against you.
Somebody knock my old ass off the hill.
We'll get him back in shape. Like now we get ready to go do this health show. Let's go do the health show.
I need a health show. On our way to the 50-50 headquarters.